Hey, we're going to lose, but
Sports
we're going to
see
money
in the WQAM Miami Fort Lauderdale presents The Neil Rogers Show. To talk to Neil, call 567-0560, toll-free for David Brower, or pound 560 on your cell phone. The opinions of Neil, his guests, callers, or anyone else on the show do not necessarily reflect those of WQAM, Beasley Reed Acquisitions, or the Beasley Broadcast Group. Now, Neil Rogers on Sports Radio 560 QAM.
Nobody repulses you more.
All right.
Tell me that you love my eyes, but I know that you keep on checking out my
side.
Don't blame you, cause I'm very cute. Check out my breath, they're poking out my lips and ears.
Oh!
You come on to me and whisper the things in my ear, and it sounds so but if you wanna date me, there's things about me I don't think you know.
Yes.
I'm underage, 17. You should be scared of me.
Okay.
Cause you could go to jail if you see with me. If I scream, you end up praising me.
She looks
25, but she's just a teen. Perfect teen. I bet my lips are free. Daddy called the cops last night. My breasts are perfect to me, because I'll have to jump in. None of my skirts reach my
knees,
and my butt just
hangs
right around of my shorts.
Rectums.
Yeah, okay.
Oh!
You should be scared of her.
Scared of me?
Rolling Stones brand made her the dynamite. What a sight. She's looking mighty fine. She looks 25, but she's just a teen.
Panel 3 at 560 WQM, happy Tuesday to you. I know the overhead's a little bit high. I got it cranked up because I love that song. I don't love the song. I love the parody that I just played, which is much better than the real song, which she couldn't sing out of a paper sack. But does anybody care about that?
No.
Of course not. Because she's got a great ass and she looks pretty good. And even if they are for real, who cares? Does anybody care if they're...
No.
No. Anyway, getting back to what they were saying right there, which I never do, but we had the monitor up, so you couldn't help but hear it whether you didn't want to hear it or not, which I didn't. But nevertheless, at the end of the worst team there this morning. See, the thing that is, and it ties in with everything else that goes on with this town, and that is... that no matter how you slap the public in the face, there are always enough assholes to perpetuate the stupidity. It would be like if I opened up a restaurant, I said, you know something? The food is really going to suck. The prices are going to be too high. The food is going to taste like crap. And I open up the doors and people come in. And they're buying my slop. Yeah, I mean, not. It's not like loaded. It's not like jam-packed like McDonald's and places like that. But nevertheless, there are people, you know, a steady flow of customers, and I'm like eking out a living. And I get out there in front on the street with a megaphone, and I say, don't you people understand the food here for at least the next couple of years? It's going to suck, and the prices are too high, and they keep showing up. That's what's going on here with this Marlin bullcrap. That's the problem. We got crazy people here.
I must be crazy. I must be nuts.
Yeah, you too, John. Yeah. Crazy people in this town. That's why this thing with Mayor Opinga, who definitely ought to be in jail after the last 24 hours, I'm convinced he ought to be on death row at least. That's why they're going to pull the wool over the eyes of this public and push this thing through. And wait till you hear this, if you haven't already heard the statement he released yesterday about the 75,000 toll boats that we're going to have if you don't give him his petty sales tax. Not that it's blackmail, you understand. No. It's unbelievable. And see, again, who are the people that are really causing the problems? That are getting sucked into all the panic? Like some jackass they interviewed this morning on Channel 4. Of course, I'm sure he was the only motorist out there available on the highway to be interviewed, but he's the one that we see in his BMW or whatever the hell he was driving. Oh, I don't care if it's 2 cents, 3 cents, whatever the sales tax is, just to get rid of these tolls and let me drive. And I'm thinking to myself, God damn it, they're going to suck the public and they're going to pull this off. They're going to pull this off. Even as transparent as it is. But getting back to the idiots again, the morons, just like the few thousand people that keep showing up for those Marlin games, even though they keep coming out and saying, oh, we're going to stink, we're not going to win, we're terrible, we're a bunch of like a little putzy kids, and every time we get somebody that you like, we're going to trade them away, even if they are still young guys and not making a lot of money, we don't care. And they still keep showing up. And it's the same with these idiots who can't figure out the 50 cents on a toll road. You know, why do we have, other than the fact that we've got lots and lots of assholes in this town who don't belong on a road in the first place, but that aside, why do we have all this massive traffic jam up? Because instead of 25 cents, it's 50 cents. You've had to have been in a cocoon the last several days not to know by now it's 50 cents on those expressways. How could you not know it? 75 cents on the turnpike. Are people doing cartwheels on the turnpike?
No.
Is traffic backed up miles on the turnpike unless there's a wreck?
No.
No. It's been that way for a long time. It's been 75 cents since back in those days when Chuck Meyer was having people mark out the thing on the quarters there, and Rick and Suds were going, isn't that a good idea? Remember those great days? On I-D?
Oh!
No, that's a long time. That's several years that it's been 75 cents. And the world didn't come to an end. But for some strange reason, you people that drive and date, and it's not like there wasn't a toll there in the first place. Do you follow what I'm saying? It's not like all of a sudden you woke up yesterday morning and there were toll booths in places where there wasn't one before. There are no new toll booths in Dade County. There's only a changed fare, and yet you're getting sucked. You're like participants in this fraud that's going on now. You're co-conspirators. You're part of the goddamn problem. Because you're so goddamn stupid, you can't figure out, okay, it's 50 cents. I'll either have a couple of quarters, or maybe I'll just have a dollar bill out and go through, or maybe even better than that, I'll get one of those SunPass things and go flying through there. This isn't like the end of the world, but now comes the Mayor Penis yesterday. I mean, this thing, it's like a script of a Broadway play, of a motion picture. It's all been written out. It's all been planned from the beginning. And he releases this statement. What's happening today is just a forecast of things to come, says Mayor Penis. And about how the Miami-Dade Expressway Authority, MDX, how this increase is just the start. And if we don't get that penny sales tax passed on July 29, there's going to be 11 new toll plazas. There'll be a toll plaza on every goddamn street corner in Dade County. And if we don't get that penny sales tax, the tolls are going up to 75 cents in 2001, and yada, 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 et cetera, and so on. And the MDX plan also calls for the tolling of future value pricing lanes and high occupancy toll lanes along proposed expressway extensions. But the mayor promises, and we know how good his word is, just like he promised to oppose that arena with Mickey Arison down there downtown, four blocks from the old arena. He says, I will not support tolling on future value pricing lanes or high occupancy toll lanes along proposed expressway extensions if you pass my penny sales tax. But you'll have to take him at his word, okay? Because we know it's his foot and toes, okay? We know that when Mayor Penis speaks that you can believe it for about a half a second. He says, with our inaction and the construction of new tolls, the complete clogging of vital streets in our community will be an everyday occurrence. So not that he's going to threaten you, and not that they put the new toll in just in time to whip up all this hysteria a couple of weeks before the goddamn election, when everybody's out of town. How come our newspapers, how come somebody in this town, somewhere in the news media, isn't psychotic about this, doing cartwheels and somersaults? It's as transparent as looking through a goddamn pane of glass with a glass been knocked out. It's a pain, all right. It's a pain in the glass. Crazy people. And, of course, you can do it here because, like I've said before, there's no passion about anything here. Oh, yeah, whatever you want. Okay, just take it. Just let me drive, okay? Whatever you want. Just rape me, screw me, stick it to me. I don't care. I love it. Just
stick it up your ass.
Right. Boy, it's amazing. And that's why we have thousands of people that show up for those ball games, because they have no life. It's going to really stink. We suck. It's going to be bad. It's going to be hot. It's going to be uncomfortable. Hey, where do we get in? How much you want? How much for that Cracker Jack? Oh. In fact, you know something? I think I have figured out why McDonald's is doing such a big business. I think I just put my finger on it, and the answer, too. 10 past 10 at 560 WQAM. Your We Tell It Too Much Like It Is for the, for everybody's own sanity station.
You can kiss my rear end.
In the evening, when I shook my teeth, I like coming something sweet. They have cheese muffins you can buy. They say there's no sugar, but that's a lie. Found sugar tonight in my muffin, but the label said NutraSweet. My doctor says I can't have nothing. It's bad for my diabetes. I'm gonna sue him or something, cause the bastard's lied to me. Hey, baby, 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 baby. Nothing goes down like a nice bran muffin. It's soft and golden brown. It's easy to gum when you want to eat something and your teeth aren't in your mouth. It's very easy on the kiss-kiss and it comes out smooth like Metamucil. It's comfortable when it shows down. Found sugar tonight in my muffin. That's bad for my diabetes. Now I'm gonna show up at something. That's the fastest life to me.
Yeah, the Muffin Man, he's out of business. What timing. Nice going there, Brian. Muffin Man closes up shop right in the Sun Sentinel this morning. Sugar-free treats not as labeled. Eatery owner faces suit filed by customer. We'll get into that in a minute. But getting back to this thing, take a look at the board right now, okay? Not one single call on there, okay, except that pain in the ass Dave Slater, which we appreciate all your good work, Dave, because you and Richard Friedman are the only ones that care beside me. But I don't really care that much because I don't live in Dade County, and especially if these things go through, I don't plan on driving them any more than I have to anyway. I mean, wait till you take a look at the westbound Dolphin and the eastbound this one and the Shula and the State Road 12 where we already took the one booth down all over the goddamn place. Every five blocks there'll be another tool booth. Another 11 more reasons why you shouldn't go to Dade County. And you people in Dade County, by the way, who've already allowed a bunch of banana boat people to take over your whole county and to run the government and turn it into the ground, turn it into a piece of crap, you're the ones who are responsible because every time they say roll over, you do it like an obedient dog. Just like you're going to do on July 29th in the middle of this bogus fixed election. They are tying up, they're creating it by intent to read this thing. Here's somebody who faxes me this brochure that's being handed out by the MDX. You see, Mayor Penis makes it sound like somehow the Miami-Dade Expressway Authority has got nothing to do with him in the county. Like it's some kind of autonomous thing, like they're not in bed together. And yet the release from the Miami-Dade Expressway Authority is talking about the toll increase and we can't waste any more time and we got to raise the money because we got gridlock, et cetera. So it says tolls are the only funding source MDX is authorized to use under its charter and toll increases are needed by July 11th in order to avoid serious delay in this important rebuilding program. Does anybody believe that? By July 11th. Not by July 30th like the day after the election, but by July 11th. It was like it was life and death that they had to get this toll increase in there by a couple of days ago in order to make sure that they had two solid weeks to get everybody crazy so they would vote yes on that penny sales tax. And they still don't give a crap. That's the best part. They couldn't care less. And, of course, you people who are in business in Dade County, you know that anybody with a brain that lives like from central Dade to North Broward or to South Broward, they're not going to shop in Dade County to pay an extra 1.5% sales tax. They're not going to do it. But don't confuse the public with the facts, because they've already gotten together behind closed doors. They made up their mind. This is what it's going to be, and nobody cares. I'm not, you know something? I'm not going to talk about it anymore. I've already done my thing. I got all whipped up to a frenzy. I don't even live in frickin' Dade County, and here's another great reason why. You know, the girl I called yesterday was talking about if I caught up with Guiding Light, you know, did I keep while I was on vacation? And I said no. And so she says, oh, there'll be no problem. When you go home today, turn it on. You didn't miss much. You'll catch right up with it. Well, I went home yesterday, 3 o'clock, turned on CBS, which I can only get Channel 4. I can't get it on the big dish because the local affiliates don't want you to be able to get the out-of-town network affiliates. And again, what are they doing? Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba with the goddamn Cubans out there in the water in the Coast Guard. 25 frickin' minutes of the same bull crap. Just like before I went away on vacation. The same repetitious crap. Do I care about Cubans out there in a goddamn, do I care about that?
No.
Do most of the people in this audience give a flying crap about this?
No.
No. But the media here, this is a place, even more than anywhere else in this very tightly controlled country, this place here in South Florida where the people are brainwashed and manipulated by the media and the politicians to such a degree that it's hopeless. It's hopeless, baby. You ain't got a prayer. Just come here and do like the old farts do.
Yeah.
Just kind of retire from life. Don't just retire from work. Retire from life. Maybe they got it right, you know? Maybe they really have it down to a science. Just live in their own little conclaves and worry about their own little selfish things and their early bird dinners and what's in it for me and where's my Social Security check. And that's it. And just escape from all the rest of it because it's hopeless anyway. The horse is out of the barn. And to watch these people and the behavior like I did Sunday coming home from the airport and see them because there's, you know, so instead of 25 cents, it's 50 cents. Okay, that was a surprise to me. But guess what? It wasn't like the end of the world. Because if you're driving around out there and you don't have the extra 25 cents, you shouldn't be driving in the first place. And yet to watch the way you people are carrying on and like all these lines and this guy this morning in his BMW. Oh, Jesus, I don't care. I make it 3 cents, 100. I don't care what kind of sales tax you put in. Just stop with this insanity. Let me say it again. There was a toll booth there already. They just increased the toll. Everybody with a brain, everybody with even a little teeny tiny one and a brain too should understand that by now. And yet they're like doing cartwheels out there in a road and they're switching one lane to another and, oh, what do I do and where do I go? And just exactly as they knew you were going to do. I mean, you talk about obedient. You talk about goose-stepping in a line. Nice going. I'm sure that Mayor Penis, he's probably stroking himself right now. He's so excited about it. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello. Oh, guess what? The phone don't work. Well, how do you like that, huh? The phone don't work. We're going to have to reboot the phone system and start all over again because this is WQA and here we go. Rebooting the phone system. Stand by. Okay, you'll have to call back in, I guess, if you're on hold, all three of you. 567-0560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. Now, don't get yourself worked up into a state, okay? You're feeling real good. You had a great vacation. You got some vinegar and whatever, a little bit of energy. Speaking of that, by the way, Hank must have lost his ass in Vegas when he was on vacation last week. He was on vacation the same time as I was, and I heard the first part of Hank's show yesterday, and boy, sounded like he must have had a really rough time out there, because usually you come back from vacation, you're loaded with energy, and you're... Thank you so much. 567, oh, that was Mayor Penis. Thank you, Mayor. Back to you. 567-0560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. Here's a mobile in Davie. Hello.
Neil, good morning.
Yes, sir.
The only thing I had to say about that toll thing, I think I'm just going to pull my car up and threaten to douse my car with gasoline. Maybe that'll get Mayor Penis's attention.
I doubt it.
And you know, I'm out of material.
Okay, great. He's out of material. Okay, nobody here has anything to say about this. I mean, I realize that I'm surrounded by a lot of dumb people out there in this town, but Jesus Christ, how is it possible to be this indifferent? How is it possible? Whatever you want, okay, whatever you want, we'll go along with it. Just please, let it, just like Howard Beale said, with your goddamn steel-belted radios and your pop-up toaster and your colored TV, and that's it. Just leave us alone. We don't care what you do. This is a place where they could come and knock on your door and pee on your front lawn and take a dump on your porch, and you still, the people here still would have nothing to say about it. Like, I don't know, like the first guy that was going to like that. That was the most accurate call of all right there. I think as of today, I think I should do myself a tremendous service and promise never ever to even get involved in any of these things again, whether it's Cubans carrying on and blocking the highways or it's corrupt politicians sticking their hand in your pocket again and screwing you in the back. What difference does it make? It's not going to change my life. Why the hell should I care when I'm living with an area of 4 million people? They don't give a crap about any of this stuff, about anything. Nothing. Let me just go to that restaurant where the food isn't so good and where they're telling me it's overpriced. Let me go and see, check that out. And then after that, I'll go see a ball game. I'll go subsidize John Henry or some other billionaire. Help him out. So I'm totally changed. You know, this thing with a stadium, they'll get a stadium. Wherever he wants to build it, they'll get a stadium. They'll find a way. They'll push it through. They'll rig it just like they're doing with this thing with the sales tax. They'll do it. They do whatever the hell they want. It's always been that way here. Because you people are oblivious. And then, of course, we got a handful, you know, and they don't do anything. Here's a mobile in wherever, in the Grove. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir?
You got to keep it up. You know why?
Got to keep what up? Talking to myself?
No, but you got to keep it up because one day they'll do to you what they did to me. They shut my business down from one day to the next here in Cuba County or Miami-Dade County or whatever you want to call it. You know, the truth is that if property taxes and that sales tax thing goes through and the property tax increase, you know, Mayor...
Okay, great. 5670560, pound 560 on the mobile. Well, he said it's bullshit is what he said, and he's right. It's a lot of shit. That's what life in Dade County is. It's a pile of shit. 5670560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. Boy, it's amazing to me. Exactly. Here's the mobile implantation. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Neil.
Yes.
I got two things to say to you. Number one, your show is fantastic. Listen to you every day.
Uh-huh.
And number two, 595 westbound is closed. There's a broad looking to jump off the 441 overpass from westbound to the south to northbound 441.
Yeah.
A little bit of information for you.
Okay, thanks for the good news. Jump now, honey, and get it over with, okay? Jump now and get it over with so we can get traffic moving again, God damn it. We got enough problems with traffic all over town, and she's holding traffic up because she's got some bug up her ass. Jump now and let's get it over with, sweetheart. I'm not going to be one of those people who gets on here and tries to, like, you know, deter somebody from doing it. Jump now and quit screwing up the traffic. Man. Boy, it sure is great to be back in town. Yeah! Why the hell would anybody want to be in all those other places that I go, you know? When you can be here having such a neat time.
What's going on with Dayton Broward?
No more muffins, baby. Boy.
I took the car to the mall. She drives my Buick and she's 3 feet tall. I wouldn't ride with her, no way. I said I'd meet her there later today. So I'm just sitting on a bench in Delray, waiting for the lolly bus to take me away.
Boy.
I'm just sitting on a bench in the lake.
Yeah.
With my friend Pine. Looks like it's time to take my change. Cause the bus fares don't always stay the same. I'm not gonna do what Jenna tells me to do. The driver at her age, she must be insane. Just sitting here, resting my bones, wondering why my wife won't leave me alone. We've talked it over, and I never win. I just wind up schlepping through the mall again. Oh, so I sit on a bench in Delray, waiting for the lorry bus to take me away. I'm just sitting on a bench in Delray with my friend's time. And there he is. It's about damn time. I've been waiting here all damn day on this bench. Where the hell have you been? Hey, where the hell are you going?
No more muffins at Yoda's in Delray Beach, baby. Live by the muffin, die by the muffin, it says in this morning's paper by Mitch Lipka. This guy that ran Gilda's, they were selling these muffins, like a lot of other places do, by the way. Sugar-free, fat-free, et cetera, and so on. And you check on the ingredients and whatever they bake them with, and you find out, surprise, not sugar-free. In fact, they were using, what is this stuff that they were using? Scoop and bake. Scoop and poop they were using to make it. And Abe Bond, 85, who suffers from diabetes, is suing a restaurant its owners for more than $15,000, claiming to have consumed large quantities of the offending muffins since 1994, and as a result, suffering disability and cost of medical and nursing care because he was eating too many of these goddamn muffins loaded with sugar. No more Gildas in Delray Beach.
Oi!
5670560, pound 560 on a mobile one line. Here in the land where they just absolutely refuse to care. Same crap yesterday. 25 minutes on Channel 4 on the CBS affiliate watching Cubans out there in the goddamn ocean with the potching around, screwing around with the Coast Guard. Hialeah, hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
You are absolutely correct, sir, on this sales tax thing.
And?
And keep hammering it.
No, no, what do you mean keep hammering it? I can't get a response. Nobody cares about this thing. Keep hammering my ass, okay? Keep hammering it. Call the hammer and tell him to hammer it, okay? See if you can wake him up.
That was funny.
God. What? I told you he must have had a bad time in Vegas. What? He never woke up once during that show yesterday. Well, he was out there at Shula's. He wasn't close by here where they can usually poke him in the ribs. He just must have had a rough time, I guess. Sounded like it. 5670560, pound 560 on a mobile one. Yeah, keep hammering away for us. We have nothing to say about it. We got no opinion. We don't really care, but keep wasting your time and your energy being the spokesman, okay? I'm tired of being the spokesman when there's no response, all right? Like farting into a windstorm, into a goddamn tunnel. What's the point? You don't even get an echo. Here's a mobile in the Grove. Hello.
I work in retail, high-priced ticket items.
Yes, sir.
This sales tax is going to hurt me.
Right.
I mean, it's going to cut into my pocket, and I don't think that... that's necessary. Second point is I just got back from a three-week vacation up to some family's house in Tennessee to do some horseback riding. I drove through Atlanta. I didn't go through one single toll road.
Yeah.
I drove through Charlotte, North Carolina. I drove all these roads. Not a single toll road.
You could drive through Michigan. It's got the best expressway system in America, and you won't find one single toll road either until you get to the Ambassador Bridge.
I mean, this is ridiculous. You can't go 15 miles here without spending $15. I mean, I've traveled everywhere, and not a single road had to be paid for by toll.
And isn't it interesting, though, that we can come up with all these creative ways to finance stadiums and arenas for billionaires? We can do that with taxes on tourists and so on. No problem at all. We can come up with the money to build Wayne Haipinga, a $200 million arena there in Sunrise. But when it comes to coming up with the money to build the roads, we have to tax the poor bastards here who, and again, how about the people that don't even use the roads who are going to have to pay the increased sales tax?
Exactly. And like I say, the sales tax is going to hurt. Where are all these people in retail? They don't think that this is going to hurt them when you sell them big ticket items. And, you know, if you sell big ticket items, that 1 cent adds up a lot.
And you know how many snorers we got down here. Even if it doesn't add up a lot, they'll spend $3 in gas just to go and buy it for $1 cheaper in Broward County.
Well, there's some people got to wake up and start thinking using their brains.
Okay, good luck, pal.
Have a good day. Bye.
Yeah, this MDX piece of propaganda they're handing out from the Expressway Authority says, you know, you do have a choice. MDX wants you to know that there may be an alternative to the new MDK tolls. On June 22nd, the Miami-Dade County Commission approved Mayor Penis's proposal for a countywide referendum for Thursday, July 29th. And if you will go ahead and vote for that thing, we'll abolish all these tolls and the world will not come to an end and the sky will not fall, et cetera, and so on. So here, you know, the mayor wants to give the impression that, like, the MDX is some kind of self-propelled authority that he's got no control over or not involved with, and yet this is a campaign that the two of them are running together. It's a blackmail campaign. They're threatening you. If you don't like what it is now, just wait, baby. We'll have a toll on every goddamn street corner. We'll build another goddamn toll booth and destroy your life if you won't let loose and give us that penny sales tax so we can do whatever the hell we want with it. And we can do the same kind of fraud that Merritt Stierheim supervised over here with the first Metro Rail election 20 years ago in that fraud. And I'm the only goddamn person in the media in this town that's sitting here spewing my guts out. And like I said, I don't know why. Didn't do any good back then. It won't do any good now. Because I see these jerkballs, these assholes, these Johnny jerkoffs this morning sitting there carrying on like the world is coming to an end because they can't figure out how to pay the 50-cent toll. Yeah. How do you do that? I guess somebody better show them how to feel the change. Here's a mobile in West Palm Beach. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay, sir.
Hey, I got a question on the satellite dish where they're taking away the network feed.
Yes.
Yeah, they say you got to get the local stations and all, and that's fine, except I got...
No, it's not fine.
Well, you're right. I got a big screen TV, and the local feeds suck.
Yeah.
So now I'm losing this stuff, and they say, I don't understand how the newspapers get around it. if there's a local...
Because the newspapers aren't regulated by the by any government agency. The newspapers don't have an FCC. The newspapers do whatever the hell they want.
Exactly. You're right. They do exactly what they want. But it's the same kind of, you know, one's a print medium, the other one's electronic, but it's information, entertainment, and advertisement. So if I get the Palm Beach Post or the Sun Sentinel locally, how come I can also get the New York Times as a Chicago Tribune or one of those?
Sir, let me, what did I just get through saying to you? The print media have no government regulating agency. There's nobody to tell them where they can distribute or what they can do because it's called freedom. You have the freedom to buy any publication you want, just like you should have the freedom to watch anything over the air that you want, especially if you're willing to pay for it, like the network affiliates from out of town. But instead, what we have is on the 30th of June, we had them all removed from our big satellite dishes, and we're forced to watch local affiliates, which, as you say, give a very grainy, subpar picture in many cases. And after, in addition to which, they just pick and choose when they're going to preempt the network programming for, like, long chunks of period at a time. Like, whenever there's a goddamn Cuban with it between here and the 90 miles to Cuba in the water, we're going to have to go away for half an hour.
Exactly. And that sucks.
You're damn right it sucks.
And, you know, I sent letters.
Ordinarily, up until June 30th, if I would have gotten home yesterday and had that crap on Channel 4, I would have just turned over to WSEE there on the satellite and watched it on the big dish and said, screw Channel 4. I don't give a crap about any more of this banana boat crap.
Exactly. Or if you have a life and you're out doing something and you miss something, you want to watch it, you know, 8 o'clock, you could pick it up at 11 on the West Coast.
Right. That's right.
And now you're screwed because you have the right to, and I agree, you should have the right to buy any newspaper you want.
And you should,
but you
have
the right to pick up any
TV program. That's right.
You're damn right. I don't know what else to do. I sent the letters to Congress.
Well,
about,
you're spinning your wheels, man. Welcome to America, where we never met a monopoly we didn't like.
Yeah, better just grab our damn passport.
Okay, pal.
All.
Good luck.
Thanks, buddy.
Oh, 5670560. Do they care?
No.
Are they ever going to care?
No.
Are they going to get motivated?
No.
Are they going to get pissed off,
no.
Fired up,
no.
Worked up?
No.
Involved?
No.
No. See, when there were the Cubans blocking the roads here a couple of weeks ago, then everybody was psychotic, and they, well, should have been. Then they were foaming at the mouth because that involved the usual old ethnic psychosis. But here we got the roads all blocked off, and everybody's having a nervous breakdown because you got a political scam being pulled off right in front of your eyes, and nobody gives a crap. Nobody's got anything to say about it. Back then, they sure had plenty to say about it. We could have done like a 5-week seminar on psychosis back when the Cubans were blocking off the roads because they didn't get their way just the way they wanted it with the goddamn Coast Guard. You people, I'll tell you right now, you've got nobody to blame but yourselves, those of you in Dade County. You've got nobody to blame. Because you've sat back, you've allowed a segment of the community to run the whole goddamn thing, and you just walk around in la-la land.
Yeah.
That's your thing. It's a toilet.
Hiya, Neil. This is Sonny with the word of the day. We're here for a good time, not a long time.
Yeah, especially in your case.
Oh, God, Neil.
Me, this is Stan Feinstein for Sofa King, you understand? Where everything is held to the high Sofa King standards. The selection isn't just huge, it's Sofa King huge. Believe me, you'll never shop anywhere else. And Sofa King's prices aren't just low, they're Sofa King low. You'll never find them anywhere else. Listen to me. When I say Sofa King has a beautiful store, I mean Sofa King beautiful. When I say the staff is helpful, I mean Sofa King helpful. Listen to me. Get to know the Sofa King and enjoy a selection that's Sofa King huge. A staff that's Sofa King courteous and prices that are Sofa King low. You'll never shop anywhere else. But don't take it from me. Take it from satisfied customer Frank Henstein.
Sofa King good.
You said it, Frankie. Sofa King good.
1046 at 560 WQAM. We have 62 open lines here. 5670560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. Hey, it's the middle of the summertime. The people with a brain, they're all out of town. They're on vacation. So what am I getting excited about? It's the same old crap you've been doing. You know, after 23 years, you'd like to think that sometime, somewhere along the line, maybe you made a little bit of difference. You said something. You did something. Is it possible here?
No.
No. So just take the money and keep making a lot of noise. Kill some time. Hallandale, hello.
And, Neil, I really can't comment on the MDX. I don't go down to Dade County without a police escort. But,
yeah.
There was a human blockade they attempted in St. Louis yesterday.
Yeah, I know.
Okay.
Probably a result of that asshole that called us from St. Louis yesterday.
Well, perhaps. He's
probably protesting his aberrant behavior.
But the difference is there, they arrested 200 demonstrators.
Uh-huh.
Mostly black, I believe.
Well,
including Reverend Al Sharpton.
Right.
And, Neil, do you ever notice the resemblance between Jeb Bush and...
Okay, 5670560, #560 on the Mobile One line. Here's Miami. Hello, I can see this is going to be a short effort today. Miami.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Go Marlins, Neil.
Yeah.
Yeah, huh?
Meaning what?
Huh? What do you want?
Meaning what?
Meaning what?
You got any material? No, you got no material. You're just another asshole, okay? Get back on a banana boat, all right, pal? Well, pack your media noche and a Cuban bullet. 5670560, #560 on a Mobile One line. Here's a Mobile in Doral. Hello.
Hey, Neil, what's going on?
Not a damn thing, pal. Same old lethargy, same old death net. You can almost smell it.
Well, I'm pretty pissed off and fired up about this penny tax.
Yeah, well, nobody else is. Nobody cares.
See, people need to realize it's going to affect every single person in Dade County, this penny tax.
Yeah.
If you calculate it, it's a penny per dollar that you waste in everything that you buy. So it's going to cost a lot more to everyone, this penny tax, than the 25 cents extra that you will be paying. Did you see this mayor yesterday on TV with his little chart showing how much the toll is going to raise, like by the year 2002, and in 2010 it'll be like up a dollar, and in 2020 it's going to be up
$1.50. I'm sure everybody here is really concerned about 2020. I'm sure we're all worried about that.
Right. The minimum wage will probably be about $15 an hour anyway.
Yeah.
You know, but I'm voting no. My girlfriend's voting no. Her sister's voting no. Her mother's voting no. No, no, no. Thank you, Neil.
No, 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 no.
Vote early and often, pal. 200-300 times apiece at least. 5670560, #560 on a Mobile One line. Here's a lady mobile in Lauderdale Lakes. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, ma'am.
I just wanted to let you know my family and I had just gotten back from Europe, and it's amazing how in Switzerland, in a city like Basel, people can just hop on and off public transportation. You don't have to wait, not even maybe a minute, two. You can get all over the city. They
right.
have wonderful roads. And I don't see anybody paying tolls about anything. And we pay, my husband has practically half his paycheck taken away from by the government for supposedly roads, schooling, and all of this business. And yet, when you stop and think about it, what, we have the worst school system? I think we're worse than Mississippi now. We
mm-hmm.
have horrible roads. They're constantly patching and unpatching them. And we have to pay through the nose for them. Now, I don't live in Dade County, but I'm fumed every time I have to go there and stop, you know, every 5 seconds along the way to pay to use these substandard roads. And I think people ought to really think hard.
But they're not going to. We can sit here and pontificate and say what they ought to do and what they ought to think. They don't care. They don't care. I'm sitting here today doing my usual begging for a phone call routines, and I would have thought when I sat down here this morning and even mentioned this again that the people would have been up in arms. But they don't care. All they do, all they want to do is hate each other. That's all they know about. So if it has an ethnic flavor to it, then they get whipped up into a frenzy about it. But if it has to do with things that affect all of us, they don't care.
And it's really so ludicrous because when you go to other places and you see how many people from all over the place live in all these cities,
yeah.
get along, and really get upset about the things that are common to everybody, as you say, education.
Well, when I go to Europe, I would never dream of renting a car or using a car. You have every kind of transportation. You've got trams and buses and subways, you name it.
It's amazing, but even if you use, my husband and I did rent a car. It was wonderful.
Yeah.
We drove all over the expressways, never had a problem. There were all kinds of gas stations, food, where you could, God forbid, get real food when you pull off on the expressway instead of plastic stuff.
Mm-hmm.
It was amazing. And why is it that we have such a problem down here? And it wasn't any better before we had all these ethnics. I mean, it's always been bad.
Well, we're too busy building arenas and stadiums, sweetheart. We don't have money for things like schools and roads. We don't have money for that.
I guess not.
We have to keep blackmailing the public and threatening them to get the money.
It almost sounds like, I hesitated to call you because it sounds like, okay, I'm sounding off, you're sounding off, and it's, as you say, we just...
Whistling in the dark. You're just whistling in the dark. These people don't care.
And it's horrible because we unfortunately have to live here. My husband has a business here. I can't take off and leave.
I live in Broward County. Other than the turnpike, I don't pay a toll anywhere, so I'm not worried about it. Somehow in Broward, we managed to survive without all the tolls.
Somehow. Let's hope it stays that way. Thanks a lot.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
567-0560, pound 560 on the Mobile One line. Just keep blackmailing and threatening and putting these little games together, and it works. That's why they do it, because it works, and because every time they do it, the Herald joins in there, and the rest of the media sits back like they got palsy, like they got the cat's got their tongue, and that's it. And they just go ahead and do whatever the hell they want, and you people sit back on your ass going,
yeah.
Like that. Yeah. Oh, my God. I mean, to see that scene with these people with the lines backed up, oh, my God. 50 cents instead of a quarter? What are we going to do? How the hell are we going to get through this thing here? How does it work? How can it be done? Man, how could they find, I've said this for 23 years and I'll keep saying it, asking the same question, how could they stick so many stupid people in the same place at the same time? That's the question for the ages. Man, where did they find them? They must have had a factory where they stamped them all out. All these people sitting there wondering, and of course they get right up to the booth. Naturally, God forbid that, you know, like should a half a mile ahead get your change out or have some kind of concept. I mean, it only has big, big green and blue signs up there, toll ahead, et cetera, and so on, how much it is. No, no, just pull in there and then start trying to finger it out. Here's a lady in Coconut Creek. Hello.
Hi, I just ended up calling the White House. You can call the White House. Anybody can get the phone number. As for, from information,
yeah,
and explain that we live down here, and the president, I didn't realize, was coming. He's not coming because of the Cuban situation or anything like that.
Right.
But the bottom line is, I would like to see an American flag flown once in a while down there. I was thinking the next time they
okay, great. Everybody call the White House and tell them we want to see an American flag flown down there, okay? Wherever down there is. Woo! See what I'm saying? That's what gets them whipped up. Let's start with the Cubans again. Let's start with the ethnic business. Let's start with all that crap all over again. Come on, here we go. That's it. Keep it up. Let's go till 2 o'clock today. That'll get them worked up. All the same people like that bitch called the White House to tell them that she'd like to see a Cuban flag stuck down here. Stick this, honey.
Stick it up your ass.
567-0560, pound 560 on a Mobile One line. Yeah, send her a Limp Bizkit, okay?
Tell her to,
great song, by the way. Not, man, what a piece of crap. What garbage. What swill. You show me a white guy trying to do rap, then I'll show you really, you know, other than Eminem, okay, I'll make an exception there, which we have to every other word that he says anyway, because he's a little on the sick side. You know what I'm saying? Like my anus. Here's, no, I don't mean my anus is on the sick side, not yet. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello?
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing, man?
Great.
I live in Miami, and the problem with a lot of these elections in Miami is they only let the city of Miami vote on them. And
no,
the
this,
city
is
of Miami,
this is a countywide.
Countywide, right,
sir,
exactly.
County election.
Which it should be defeated easily, because most people in the county should realize that 25 cents would be much better than another penny sales tax.
Mm-hmm.
But most of the, like, the Miami issues, it's voted on such a small percentage of the actual, you know, when you consider Miami, you got to consider Kendall and, you know, the Gables and all the other areas. And they don't get to vote on it, so it really...
But what does that have to do with this? This is
an understanding,
and you just got through saying it's a countywide election.
Right. On a countywide election...
That's being held in the middle of the summertime when at least 50% of the people who live in the county are out of town.
Well, that's a political thing that they've rigged, and of course they're going to try to... You know, which is a joke, because the mayor is a joke, and he tries to make it seem like his way with the penny tax would be easier. You know what? It costs $3 to get into Manhattan... It costs money to drive sometimes, and that's all you have to, you know, 50 cents. If you don't have 50 cents to pay for a toll, you shouldn't be driving.
Park it and get it off the road, that's right.
I mean, you know, it's real simple. But the whole city of Miami, as long as we have the same politicians running the city of Miami, it'll never change. And, you know, the bigger the city grows, with the more people that come into the city, the harder it gets for anything to change. It doesn't seem like it's going to change anytime soon.
Okay, I'll see you in Broward. 567-0560, pound 560. I'm so depressed. I'm so sorry that I came back here. I can't begin. There are no words for me to describe how depressed I am that I came back to this place where the people are so goddamn indifferent, so uninvolved, so asleep, so lethargic, so pathetic. Their behavior, this, like I said, these people out there in the road with this backed up a mile because there's been a 25-cent increase and putting on a show just exactly what the politicians predicted and hoped for and prayed. If they would have written a script, you couldn't have acted out better for them. Including that jackass they had on Channel 4 News this morning. Sir, I hope they charge you 80% sales tax on everything you buy, okay? Just because you're such a jackass. Yeah, I don't care what it is, 2%, 5%, just get me out of this traffic. Woo! Exactly. Sports Radio
560. And now, Dr. Jeremy Burnham with a dramatic reading of No Scrubs by TLC. Dr. Burnham?
A scrub is a guy that thinks he's fly, also known as a buster. Always talking about what he wants, just sits on his broke ass. So no, I don't want your number. No, I don't want to give you mine. And no, I don't want to meet you nowhere. No, I don't want none of your time. And no, I don't want no scrub. A scrub is a guy that can't get no love from me, hanging out the passenger side of his best friend's ride, trying to holler at me. No scrub. No scrub. No, no. No scrub. No, 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 no. No scrub. No, no. No.
Goddamn fucking idiot.
1102 at 560 WQAM. So anyway, here's a fax from Bob Barron. Who the hell is Bob Barron? That's not the old, this is a Bob Barron with the Miami Fusion, is that it? Acción Internacional, yeah. And anyway, this guy sends the fax to the first team complaining bitterly about how they're always bashing soccer. He sends it to our fax machine. So, Bob, it's very articulate. You're full of crap, though, by the way, because the guys in the morning are right. Nobody here cares about soccer, whether it's the Fusion or the Confusion or the whatever it is, the Confluence. Nobody cares. So give it a rest, Bob, and next time you want to send a fax to the first team, send it to their fax machine. It'll maybe get to them. Because every time we get a fax that's even close to being for the worst team, we tear it up immediately without even reading it because that'll piss off Defoe and his mother. Oh, sorry, Betty. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Yeah, hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay, sir.
Neil, I hope anybody who, before this vote comes up, uses their brains and some mathematics and realizes a car is going to cost you $200 to $300 more.
They're not
going to
do that. People aren't mathematicians. They're emotional creatures. And what's being done now, this whole scam that's being orchestrated now to work on the emotions and the frustrations of the drivers in Dade County, which is the people who are going to be here in 2.5 weeks to vote on this thing, that's what's going to influence them, not dollars and cents. They're not going to sit down with a calculator and figure these things out.
Yeah, because, I mean, I chose my work according to where I live to eliminate driving. That's my choice. If they choose to drive to downtown Miami, it's going to suck whether there's a toll booth or not.
Yeah.
But it's going to cost us a restaurant. It's going to cost us a washer dryer, a big screen TV, anything you buy. We're going to be giving money up. And if we don't drive it, we're paying for it.
Yeah.
So, I just hope people use their brains, but that's asking a lot in this county.
Okay, good luck, sir.
Have a good one.
To us all. Yeah, well, he starts with a brains business. That's when I start getting really nervous because I keep wondering what brains he's talking about. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T wireless line. The Hank Goldberg Show, I'm sure Hank will be awake by today. You know, that first day back from vacation is always tough. He'll be on here from 2 to 6 this afternoon. 6 o'clock, we got Jim Mandich.
Yeah.
And then 7:45, we got that All-Star game, which the 10 people who are interested in that will be watching it on TV. But we got it because it kills some really good time. And then Ed Kaplan after the game, I'm sure. Am I right about that? 5670560, #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Homestead. Hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay, sir.
Never figured you for an Eminem fan. Have you heard the new Sway and DJ Tech CD with one new track from Eminem and one where he's doing a bunch of stuff with a bunch of other hip hop artists?
Yeah, I saw one of the cuts last night on was
the anthem.
What was it?
The cut that you saw was called The Anthem.
I don't know, a ton
of people in there. This guy named Chino and
a couple other guys. That wasn't the one.
It was funny because I went to the Eminem show, which I didn't see you at, but there was maybe like 20 people in the over 21 section over there at the Cameo.
Yeah.
Because they, you know, of course, they were like alcohol upstairs. And it was like, oh, a bunch of 15-year-olds. And I looked around and said, I'm getting old, but my tastes are still young, Neil. You know what I mean?
I know what you mean.
All right. Take it easy.
Okay, see ya. What do you say? 5670560. I think what he said was that Limp Bizkit sucks, and he's absolutely right. Their album came on Billboard, by the way, number one the first week. He showed you the American music. Oh, God. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Toy Box, you ever going to hear from them over here?
No.
I doubt it. Just like when I came back from vacation that other time and played Steps. Oh, Neil, that's the worst record we ever heard in our lives. Okay. 9 minutes after 11 at 560 WQM. You stick with Jennifer Lopez, okay, and I'll stick with Toy Box. Anybody out there got a toy box?
Dolphins football. Sports Radio 560 QA.
Okay, let me let you in on a little bit of a secret, okay? We already know about the broad on 595 and 441, okay? No more phone calls about it. No more faxes about it. We already had it on the air. We know about it. There's nothing we can do about it, okay? I told her to jump already and get it over with so I can clear the traffic and get you all going again, but that's the best I can do. Man, oh man, oh man alive. What a place this is. It's just staggering. It's just amazing. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. I want my salad from Chuck's, by the way, for lunch. I want that real nice salad he does, you know, with the cold cuts and the cheese and stuff like that. Soon. Really soon. I need salad for my brain. Here's a mobile in Miami Lakes. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing? I just wanted to go by this thrower off the bridge. Hey, listen, I stopped by a dealership in Esserman Nissan in Miami. You're not going to believe this. First of all, nobody speaks English there. And they got Santa Claus and Christmas trees and Christmas lights up already.
Yeah.
You need to tell those Cubans this is July.
5670560. You see what I'm saying? That's all you people want to talk about. That's all you know. The thing that's got to do with Mayor Penis here, other than the fact that he's a professional Cuban, but other than that, this is all of Dade County. It's not an ethnic thing. And we get the one broad, the old bitch that's on the phone at the White House, where you're looking for somebody with an American flag down there. She don't even live in Dade County, but she's got a big mouth worried about what kind of flag they're waving down there. And then we got this guy in here who's going out of his way to go to Dade County to look out for people who can't speak English. That should be real tough, sir, looking for people who can't speak English in Dade County. We'll get you a search party. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T. The town that doesn't work, folks. Don't let anybody pull the wool over your eyes for even a half a second. This place doesn't work. Here's Kendall. Hello.
Yes, Neil.
Yes, sir.
To go and shoot down anybody's idea of going up to Broward and avoiding the sales tax increase, I can tell you, because I did this myself, went up to buy my car because sales tax was cheaper in Broward.
Yes.
That was in 92. And they had to charge me the sales tax regardless and send it back to Dade County. So if if anybody thinks that they can go out of...
You mean you live in Dade County?
Because I resided in Dade County,
yeah.
They had to charge me the Dade County.
Well, move to Broward. That's my suggestion, sir. 5670560, pound 5, although in your case, stay in Dade. Pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Plantation. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay, sir.
Hey, did you ever find out some good bratwurst yesterday?
No, I did not.
Okay. Most of it's not where you buy it, but how you prepare it. How are you cooking it?
What do you mean by that?
How do you cook the bratwurst?
Yeah.
How do you cook it? Just like throw it in the grill, or what do you do?
Oh, how do I cook it on the grill?
Right, how? Okay, well, before you put it on the grill, try this. This is what we used to do in the Midwest. Take it in a big pot of boiling water, put about a half a can of beer in it and some onions.
Yeah.
And boil the bratwurst in that beer and water mixture for about 10 minutes.
Yeah.
And then take it out and throw it on the grill.
Okay.
It'll taste a lot better.
But where am I going to find it?
Okay, well, you can find it. Well, do you want to go and have it in either the restaurant? Have you ever been to the Barbarian Village in Hollywood?
The Barbarian Village?
Uh-huh.
You mean the Bavarian Village?
Barbarian Village, right.
Do they have a deli?
I don't think you can take it out there, but you can sit down and eat it.
No, I don't want to sit down and eat. I want to take it home and make it, like on the grill, you know?
Well, the best stuff that you can find is Johnsonville Bratwurst. It's either Winn-Dixie or Publix.
No, Publix has got no bratwurst. I was in my Publix last night. I scoured in there. They don't have any bratwurst.
Go to another Publix. Go to one down by work.
The one down here by work?
Well,
out here on 441?
God forbid, no.
Okay,
thanks
for the good news, pal. Okay. Woo! I know, excuse me. I get carried away. I was in Cologne, Germany. They have very good bratwurst there, and I come back here, and right away I think I'm still in Germany. Okay, I'm sorry. I apologize. I got a little bit carried away. I mean, something as unreasonable as that to expect to be able to walk into a market. Overtook my brain there? I just had a brain fart, I guess. Assuming I could walk like into a supermarket or into like a deli where they have like actual like sausages and bratwurst and all these things. Excuse me. Here's Coral Springs. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
What's going on, man? What's the deal? Yeah, I heard you talking about white rappers. Do you like Eminem? I know a white rapper that you like. He's from Miami.
Yeah.
His name is Seema. I saw him at the R. Kelly concert. You know where they had the gunshots and the stabbings and all that?
Yeah.
Seema's the man. You got to check him out.
No, I'll pass. 5670560, rap sucks, okay? Rap is for morons. Rap is for idiots. You got it, pal? Rap is for people without a brain. Rap, they left the C off it, okay? They left the K off the beginning of the word. They left the K off of crap. You got it, pal? Here's a mobile in Deerfield Beach. Hello.
Neil?
Yes, sir.
Just got back from Vegas. Loved it.
Yeah.
State of the Mandalay Bay. I wanted to ask you, though, I was watching TV for a couple of minutes, and I see they had the ads for the Tom Likas radio show. How come they don't do it down here? They don't have ads for your show. There are a lot of people.
Because I work for a bunch of cheap bastards, sir, who don't promote this station and don't promote this show, and it's a miracle we have any audience because I work for cheap bastards called the Beasleys and Greg Reed, who's busy in Montana right now, and that should tell you a lot about his personality.
I mean, they're advertising him like every 20 minutes.
Yeah, well, we don't get any advertising.
And,
we get
down
nothing.
Here, I've been listening to you now for about 11 years,
right.
10 years, and there are people, when I say Neil Rogers, they go, who?
Exactly, that's right.
Unbelievable. That's all I've got to say. Love you, Neil.
Thank you, sir. Okay, there it is, a little salt in the wounds. I mean, his intentions are good, but he doesn't seem to want to accept the fact that I work for cheap pricks who don't want to spend any money to promote us because, somehow we still manage to fumble our way through without it. And they load up the log with 8 million spots, and then they got to give all the money to John Henry and to Wayne, and it's just a vicious cycle here. But in the meantime, like Hank says, just take the money. Like Geldy says, like everybody around here says, if they've been here long enough, just take the money and run. And they're right. They're absolutely right. Because otherwise, you could go nuts. You could have a nervous breakdown from these people, the absolute refusal, the inability. They just, don't want to have anything to do with the way this business is supposed to be conducted, and they want to stick it up the butt all the time. But nevertheless, some people around here might like that. Here's a lady in Miami. Hello.
Neil?
Yes, ma'am. Can't hear you at all.
Okay. I think the reason that you probably haven't got much response from people concerned about the penny sales tax is that most of the folks that would have been concerned are not living in Dade County anymore. The few that are still left here that would be concerned, they're just waiting for retirement so that they can leave Dade County as well.
Yeah.
It is unfortunate
to say it. It's finished. Dade County is history.
Yep. That's
you're right.
Truth. All right. Bye-bye.
Thanks. Now, she's right. Very succinct, right to the point. She's absolutely correct. By the way, before I forget about it, yesterday I was mentioning the Newsweek magazine, July 12th, and probably some people went out to the newsstand, and they thought, what is he talking about? Is God dead on a front page article? Because yesterday in the mail at home, I get my July 12th issue of Newsweek, the U.S. edition, not the European one that I bought, where the hell was it, in Amsterdam at the airport. And lo and behold, on the front cover of the one here, Latin USA, the article I was talking about with Bill Dreckener and Out Loud and all that bullcrap, those really obnoxious, repugnant, unacceptable articles, that's the front page story. Now, the thing about is God dead in Western Europe, it sure can look that way, and all the statistics and the other stuff that I read, is that story in here at all?
No.
Is there any mention?
No.
Is it?
No.
No. How do you like that? So you see, in Europe, in Newsweek, they can handle this. They can handle the facts, and they can deal with it because they realize that it's all a bunch of bullcrap. But the American public, who are so brainwashed with the religion and horse crap, they got to have this garbage on the front page with Bill Dreck talking out loud. Good show there, Bill. That was good. Yeah, that was great. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay, sir.
Listen, I plan on voting no against the sales tax that's coming
no.
up this month.
Yeah.
And I think I'd like to tell you a little story here. I bought the SunPass to use on 836, and they've made every lane a SunPass lane. So therefore, you're stuck in every lane with backed up. It's crazy.
Well, what do you mean every lane is a SunPass lane? How can they do that?
They did it. Every lane has a big metal sign over the lane that they accept SunPass. So
yeah.
Therefore, everybody, even the people that don't have SunPass, can get in those lanes. So it's not
So in other words, you're saying on the 836 there are no exclusive SunPass lanes?
You got it, baby.
Brilliant. Thanks for the good news.
Hey, also, too, it doesn't matter if they take out these toll plazas or not. 5 years from now, traffic's going to double. 10 years, it's going to double. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. Well, guess what? What they don't understand is 5 years from now, 90% of the people will move out of Dade County, so it really doesn't make any difference. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a lady in Kendall. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, ma'am.
I thought of you on Saturday evening. I was watching E.T. Entertainment Tonight, and you remember when you were raving about Jeff Popovich?
Yes.
The UM player?
Right.
Well, his brother Doug is far more gorgeous. I guess they were
Marley. How can you say that? They're identical twins.
They are?
Yeah.
Well, they don't look identical.
They sure look like it to me.
Well, now I wonder. So I thought the one boy's already graduated.
Yeah. Well, maybe they're not.
I don't
but they sure
that.
Look like it in the pictures I
oh,
saw.
Oh, well, wait till you see the other fellow.
I did see him. I've got the thing.
Oh, okay.
That it was in the catalog for Abercrombie & Fitch.
All right. That's what they're modeling, yeah.
Right.
You'll
notice when I brought that up, everybody around here went mum. One or two people admitted they heard of him. He wears number 38 or whatever for the Hurricane. But all of a sudden, as soon as they found out that he was a male model, everybody and these sports people went mum like they never heard. I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Oh, it's
just unbelievable.
Stupid, yeah. What you were talking about, bratwurst, do you have a boar's head section in your Publix?
Yes.
Well, in the big Publix down here on US-1, they have the bratwurst in that section.
Really?
Uh-huh. So you might double-check it.
I think I'm going to have to talk to my people over there at Publix because
I don't
like to be pushy and start bossing them around. But, I mean, is it like un-American to go in there and buy bratwurst? Is there something wrong with that?
No. They'll order it for you.
Okay.
Okay. Thanks. Bye-bye.
5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Bratwurst report. It's called ML, E-M-I-L, ML sausage. Eva Braun is behind the counter whacking them up and making them.
Yeah.
You have to take Federal Highway, north of Commercial.
Okay, thanks a lot, pal. And when you get to Jacksonville, by the way, make a U-turn, come back to Daytona, and that's where it is. Don't you understand? I mean, every time I ask, where can you get, fill in the blank, where do you get, yeah, whatever it is. And it's like, oh, well, if you drive up to Commercial and you go all the way over to Federal Highway and you make a U-turn and spin around just past Schloimies, I'm not talking about that. We're not talking rocket science here. We're talking about buying some goddamn meat. That's what we're talking about, okay? Where's the frickin' meat? 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. I'm not talking about that toll thing anymore. I'm never gonna get sucked into that thing. It's the worst. I don't live in Dade. I work just barely over the county line, and I hop on the turnpike, which the tolls will continue to be there, and it doesn't bother me in the least bit. And life goes on. And you people live in Dade, screw you, okay? You don't give a crap, screw you. I'm not gonna sit here and keep being the spokesman and tearing my guts out for a bunch of people that don't give a crap. Screw it. Good luck to you, you'll need it.
Beware of exploding balls.
Yes, I'm a malcontent Leo who floated into town. And when I read a herald, I just can't put it down. Since all the gringos moved away, they ought to try to get the El Miami Herald to change its name instead to Miami Pandora. Miami Pandora.
Yes.
It makes my tongue roll and roll and roll and roll. Then it's perfect for a town where there's no life to be found. Outside of what we do the best, like robbing ATMs and shooting tourists in the head, El Herald caters to the arrogant and hostile Julio. It's Camudista, this and that, that's all you need to know. I read it when I get a case of black bean squirt, and then I wipe my ass on my Guayabara shirt. The Miami Pandora, Miami Pandora, you think my tongue. The Miami Pandora, Miami Pandora, you think my tongue. They're a world-class city, aren't we? Yes, according to Channel 4, anyway.
By the way, did I mention I hate bratwurst? It's the trade. Pork. 11:32 at 560 WQM. Rafael Resendez Ramirez Schwartz Poopy Campo, they caught him, okay? The railway killer is in custody. Happy now?
Oh!
And Broad is still hovering over 595 and 441, we think. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Weston. Hello.
Neil?
Yes, sir.
You can solve your sausage problem on the way home from your office today.
If you, as you go over towards the turnpike to go home,
mm-hmm.
keep on going to to University and go up and a block north of Johnson Street on University, there's a place called International Sausage. It's a European guy that's been here, probably has his kids and his mother-in-law and everybody else working there. They make the sausage, they smoke the sausage,
they're smoking it,
right there on the side. And they're very reasonable, very nice people, and they've been here 100 years.
And it's on University.
Yes, sir. Right, it's literally a block north of Johnson Street, right next to the Citgo station.
Okay. Thanks a lot.
Have a nice day.
There you go. That solved that problem. No more meat, okay? Enough of the meat. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a Lady Mobile in Miami. Hello.
Well, you just said no more meat. I was going to tell you about getting the real sausages out of Cologne, but never mind.
Go ahead.
Well, it's going to be a drive for you. There's a German deli up in Boynton Beach.
They're
actually German. They'll order you by the case, and you can freeze it.
No.
But they bring it in from Germany.
Yeah.
A lot of this other stuff, like the Johnsonville, it's very Americanized. I was in Cologne a couple years ago, and Johnsonville's okay, but the real good stuff you can get from that deli up there. There's another one down here in South Bay, but I know you don't come today. So.
No way. I can't afford the tools.
Oh, well, sorry.
Thanks.
Bye.
5670560. We finally hit the raw nerve here today. We hit the meat line. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. North Miami, hello.
Hey, Neil?
Yes, sir?
I'm another meat guy. I'm sorry. I've closed my business. I'm here cleaning up. I've been listening to you for years. I'm in Dade County, and I'm leaving.
Really?
Yeah, I moved to Broward 4 years ago when they jacked the insurance up so you couldn't even live here anymore.
Yeah.
And now my business, I'm closing it, and I'm moving to Broward County. And my sausage place is real near you, and it's the original guy from the one on University.
Yeah.
And he makes it in the shop, and it's on Biscayne Boulevard, two blocks from Pembroke Road going north.
Biscayne Boulevard and Pembroke Road, we're in two different counties. You mean Federal Highway?
No. Biscayne Boulevard. It's
Biscayne Boulevard. Biscayne Boulevard is in Dade County. Pembroke Road is in Broward County. Never the twain shall meet. Biscayne
right.
Boulevard turns into Federal Highway.
U.S. 1, just north of Pembroke Road. You know what? We're on the Gulf Stream side, but the road.
I wouldn't go anywhere near there.
No. He's very good. He's European. He
probably
makes
running
it right
to Sonny
there.
Rosenberg over there.
Boy!
Well, good luck to you, pal.
Yeah, you too, Neil.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Okay, 600 open lines here this morning. It's really desperate, okay? I apologize profusely for getting all worked up about that stupid mayor penis. I don't care about that crap, okay? I just don't care. If you don't care, why the hell should I care? We just don't care, right? Is that it?
Uh-huh.
Okay. I should have checked before I started this morning, taken a survey. Do you care? And they all would have said,
no.
Then we could have moved on with life, talked about something important like where we get some good meat. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
You know, that guy was right on University around Johnson.
Yeah.
He makes all kinds of different sausages, real good.
Mm-hmm.
And he'll even make them for you if you have a special recipe like of your own, or, you know, or something you want to leave out, something that you can't eat or something. He'll do that for you too.
Mm-hmm.
But also 95 southbound, a car exploded. It's on fire. Traffic is stopped. At 84,
yeah.
right underneath the overpass.
All right.
I mean, big fire. The
all
cars
right.
are not moving.
Excellent. Thanks for the good news. Thank you.
I know your traffic report won't say it, though.
No, we don't have any traffic reports. I have a TV set here with the small satellite dish. I have no contact with the outer world. We don't have a news wire in this station.
Well, there's three helicopters looking.
Yeah.
It's not as exciting as the boats floating in, but it's something.
Okay, thanks for the good news. Yeah, see, we have no contact with that. We don't have the cable. We don't have, the antenna farm is only across the street from us, you know, if we were going to get. And by the way, what are we going to do about that Chuck situation?
I just tried again.
Which maybe his phone is off the hook or it's out of order. Maybe he heard me say that we were going to get food from over there and they took the phone off the hook. Chuck, if you're listening, what the hell's going on with your phone? What are you looking like that? I mean, we're going to have to get some lunch in here pretty soon, and I'm really horny for Chuck's, that really spicy, whatever the thing is. But evidently, 5-6-7, you finally got a ring. See, he probably had phone was off the hook. He heard what I said. See, if you're going to communicate, you got to get on the air because Chuck's the one guy that's listening today. He's the only one. 5-6-7-0-5-60, pound 560. I'm just going to play Toy Box and Best Friend the rest of the day over and over again. I like it. Of course, if you haven't seen the video, it loses something in translation. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Neil, what's going on, big man?
Not a thing, pal.
Hey, talking about this penny tax bullcrap. You know that day that you were talking about that they raised tolls to 50 cents and all that crap?
Oh. Yeah, I'm listening.
Not only did they raise it to 50 cents, they had, out of the seven possible lanes to get through there, they had three of them closed.
Yeah.
Just to piss people off more. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
But now it's a jackass.
Okay, thanks for the good news. That's a bulletin, in case you missed it. One line lit up on the board, then we can go back to some music. I'll play that, what is that thing that I got from Norway? Unforgivable Sinner by Lene Marlin. That's number one in Italy, very big. I'm going to play just European music. Since these people got nothing to say. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T line. Why in God's name, seriously, if there is anything in the universe, if there's anything out there, if even Mr. Spock is listening, why in the world did I come back to a place like this?
Where's my meat?
Crapital Records is proud to present the Elvis album everyone's been waiting for. It's Elvis in Seattle.
I don't mind stealing bread from the mouths of decadence. I'm getting hungry. Hey, Red, give me a cheeseburger, man, and see if the Colonel's got any leftover lasagna. I'm getting hungry.
That's right. The King of Rock and Roll is playing the Kingdom, and you've got a front row ticket.
Will and Jeremy spoke in class today.
Elvis covers all the great Seattle bands, Pearl Jam, Soundgarden, and the one that started it all, Nirvana.
Oh, man, I'm a lotto, my mosquito. My libido.
Elvis is wearing flannel and rocking Seattle. Only on Crapital Records and Tape.
Man, SpaghettiOs. Got some Cheetos. And some Po-Hos. Mashed potatoes.
1144.
Thank you very much.
560. You're welcome, WQM. So anyway, Joe Costello's mom calls and says that the sausage shop that these people are recommending, the Old World, whatever the name for it was, that it sucks. And that the good stuff is in Hollywood Mall in that deli, which I know that place where that German guy runs it. It's a German sausage shop. Am I going to the Hollywood Mall? Huh?
No.
Is anybody else going there?
No.
No. But thanks, Mrs. Costello. Thanks for the memories, and I won't waste my time going there on University in Johnson because she said it sucks. By the way, Channel 10, big expose yesterday. They got nothing better, no important news going on. So what do? They take a bunch of teenagers, and they send them out to various movie theaters around town. Did you see that thing? To see who's getting ID'd and who's not getting ID'd into those R-rated movies. Oh, my God. America, grow up already. Because Bubba said...
Outrageous.
Yeah, the same guy that's up there getting blowjobs and sticking the cigars in every orifice he can. That's why they call it the Oval Orifice. And he's hocking a trinic about, now we got to start checking IDs and make sure, because then we don't have to worry about violence, okay? As long as you make sure your kids don't go to these sexual and violent movies, God forbid. I mean, is there anybody who, in their right mind, who really believes this goody-two-shoes bullcrap approach to life?
No.
Of course not. Does he believe it?
No.
Here's a mobile in Doral. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, been a long time, probably 5 years. I'm your long-lost Volusia County Nazi sheriff correspondent, Bob Vogel, that makes the minority stops up on I-95. At any rate, I live near Daytona Beach, and I make 60% of my income driving on Miami-Dade County roads. And if they take the tolls down, it'll be a blessing for me. But you know what? I don't spend tax dime number one. I sleep in Broward for safety purposes. And when I'm in a hotel down here, so for 9 years I've been listening to you on Mondays and Tuesdays, and now they're going to do this. It's only going to benefit me, but I don't spend any money in Dade County. So,
yeah.
What an asinine move. It's absolutely unbelievable. And just for the record, the troopers are in on it now, too, up in 95. So you guys that are running drugs, you may want to get on US 1 before you get to the Port Orange exit 85.
Okay, thanks for the good news. Thanks for the warning.
Take care.
Oh, God.
Ah, oh, Jesus, are you f***ing kidding me?
Oh, that's right. Don't let those kids under 17 see that South Park movie. They're definitely going to be blowing each other's brains out. They might even stick one of those Cuban bullets in there.
Rectum.
From Nick's. Oh. Crazy, crazy country, man. Let's just keep everybody like a 10-year-old, like a 5-year-old, and then we don't have to worry about anything, you know? 5670560, #560 on the, of course, the NRA. We want to make sure all the kids can keep buying all the guns they want. That's okay. But don't let them buy a pack of those faggots or see some of those movies like South Park and all these other damn things. God.
Because they're a bunch of assholes.
That must be it. Here's a mobile in Cape Coral. Hello.
Neil, God.
Yes, sir.
Tom Green for Canadian president.
Right.
Tom
Green doing those Pepsi spots for the first time on MTV last night. Nice going, Tom.
Oh, yeah. He's the man. I left Dade. I left Broward. Now I live in Fort Myers, and there's some civility out here. People are nice and respectful.
I think the word you're looking for, though, is boring. I mean, it's pretty boring here. I can't even imagine how boring it's got to be there.
It's changing. Neil,
they probably got some nice stookies there, you know, along I-75 and some of those exits. They probably got a nice stookie.
You got to stay around the beach or even downtown Fort Myers. They have a little area there, good cafes, bars.
No.
Got to go out late night. That's it.
No.
And the people here are getting younger.
Yeah. Oh, sure. They're under 70 now?
Exactly.
Median age is down to 69. That's the only 69 you'll find over there, but that's the median age.
You know what the most frustrating part about listening to your show now is that I have to get filled in on all this Cuban, you know, hokey stuff going on.
You don't want to hear it anymore. You don't want to know about it, believe me. Trust me.
Hey, can I call somebody douchebag?
Yes, sir.
Lenny, you're Cuban. Get out of Miami. And I love my dad.
Okay.
Thanks, Dale.
Okay. 5-6-7. So we finally got through to Chuck. What was the story? Was the phone off the hook?
They got a couple of really big orders that they were dealing with.
Well, you know, you got some goddamn nerve, mister. I mean, they got a couple of big orders. That means that somebody is actually paying for it. We're looking to sucker up a free lunch from them over here and disrupt their taking the big orders, and you got some nerve getting on the air and making a big stink about that. Oh, I did? 5670560. I'm going back on vacation. I'm serious. This really sucks. Yesterday for a Monday, it was okay. It was weak. Pretty crappy. But today, my God, to come in here and actually, you got to pinch yourself every now and then, make you understand that you're awake and alive. Maybe that's what Hank needed yesterday. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hi, Neil. Good morning.
Yes, sir.
You know, I was in Cuba recently, and they listened to you there in 560 and in 770.
Yeah.
770 has a program before you that, if you ever wanted not to follow somebody, that's the program.
Really?
They got a guy that his whole program for 3 days was about the fight that he had with his wife, and his wife threw him out of the house, and he called his wife in the job, and she said, I don't want to talk to you.
I didn't know they carried Rick Riley on 7-7.
Oh, no, it's one of the local jokers.
Oh, man. I see.
Real. Listen, channel.
At least it wasn't Don Imus talking about his brother Fred on the air.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, Jesus.
It wasn't
God. How is that man still on the air? It just astonishes me.
A report from Channel 23 on Ileana Rose Lettiner. She is demanding from the Coast Guard to return to Miami the body or the corpse of the lady that drowned over the weekend.
Yeah, what's she going to do with it?
Well, they wanted to set up a big show, a big event here, even though the family of this young woman is in Cuba.
Huh.
Her husband and family.
Maybe they can turn the body over to the Tom Green Show on MTV.
Uh-huh. So she's
they
demanding.
Could probably come up with some pretty creative things
she
to do with
demanding
it.
That. And today at 5 o'clock, they're going to have a picketing, huge picketing, they said, against Bill Clinton in the entrance to Coco Plum.
Yeah.
Coming to a fundraising. And Mayor Penelas is going to be there.
Uh-huh.
Senorita Penelas.
Mayor Penurius is going to be there?
Mayor Penelas, yes.
Right.
So,
and maybe OJ will be there at the same time.
Oh,
the Coco Plum.
That would be a good combination.
Excellent.
Maybe OJ will be there with his big knife.
Could be. Okay, thanks. not that we meant anything by that, Mr. Mayor, but you got to watch your backside. You know what I'm saying?
Rectum.
Yeah. Oh, boy. I can't deal with it anymore. It's just too much of the same. That's why we all moved out of Dade, okay? If you live in Dade, don't take it personally unless you want to. We just can't stand it, okay? If that's your idea of the way you want to live, fine. It's a free country to a point. Yeah, if that's what you want, fine. We don't want any part of it. Broward may have a lot of very old people, and we may be very, very boring and very stale, but you know something? Sometimes stale isn't all that bad. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Listen, Johnsonville sausage, the best. Johnsonville brats.
From what?
Johnsonville Brats. They're the Wisconsin Bratwurst, and they have it all Publix's. They're supposed to.
No, they don't.
Oh man!
If they have Bratwurst in my Publix, they must be hiding it in a place to, just to make sure I can't find it.
Unbelievable.
I'm going in there again this afternoon. I'm going to turn that store upside down looking for brats.
Yeah, but ask for Johnson.
Looking for Kraut.
Those are the real Wisconsin brats.
Okay.
Okay, and in closing, Mayor Penis, you're an asshole.
Thank you. What did he say?
He's an asshole.
5670560, #560 on the AT&T line. Don't forget, just vote.
No.
Mayor Martinez, my good close friend Raul from Hialeah, he's coming out against the penny sales tax today. Always loved that Raul Martinez, you know what? Seriously, there's a hell of a guy. You don't mess with him.
That was funny.
Yeah. Don't monkey around with him at all. 5670, if you don't mess with a falcon or you get the claw. There's a word that goes in there, but you know what it is. Huh? Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Neil, can't we just vote no on both things, the quarter and the penny?
The quarter's not on the ballot.
Oh,
either give him the penny or he's going to give you the shaft. That's the way it works.
How come it's like that? I mean, it's like pick your poison, you know?
No, he's not. It's either your
yes
or
no.
That's it.
Oh, okay. Well, in closing, Mayor Pinellas es un ojo de culo.
Okay. Okay.
Rectum.
5 6. It was something about he's got nice brown eyes. He said 5670560 and #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Never looked into his eyes, to be honest with you. He looks kind of unappealing to me, to be very, very level with it. He's just boring. But he's young, and he's different, and he's vibrant. He's the same old crap, okay? He's owned Lock, Stock, and Barrel. And this whole deal here, Merritt Steerheim, it's got the same rotten smell that it always has in this town, and always will. With the stamp of the Herald, right? Even though they moved out of town, Knight Ritter, they're still here screwing things up. Here's a mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Neil?
Yes, sir.
Hey, you want to talk about, you know, you say it's a fixed election already. Look, right now, they're probably messing with the tolls, mixing things up, making it so complicated for people to get through there that people are just going to want to vote yes for this toll thing.
Exactly. That's what this whole thing is about. In fact, you know, you raise a point. They probably have instructed the toll takers, and I don't want to confuse with my good friends on the turnpike, the toll takers, because they're very nice people, most of them. But the people on those toll roads there in Dade County, they probably instructed them to be as inept and incompetent as possible to make sure that this is the biggest disruption in these people's lives so that they'll get sucked into voting for that goddamn penny sales tax.
That's exactly right. They're fixing the election. We don't even know it.
Right.
So, thank you.
Okay. Vote early and often.
No.
I'm not going to talk about it anymore, but
no.
Vote no. I will not talk about it again until tomorrow. What? I mean, the election is like 2 weeks from the day after tomorrow. It's 16 days away, July 29th, the day that the spring book comes out. And if we could only rig the goddamn numbers in the book the same way they're going to rig this election, we'd be in good shape. We'd have a 30 share. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Neil?
Speaking.
Good afternoon. How are you?
Great. Good morning.
All right. Long-time listener, first-time caller.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm sorry. At any rate, did you consider Penn Dutch Meats?
Yeah, I asked George about that the other day. I would assume that Penn Dutch Meats would have bratwurst, you would think, since they have all these other kinds of, every other kind of meat that's ever been invented.
Oh, okay. Well, I thought maybe you might want to try that, but since you've already considered
I mean, I thought about it, but I just don't know for sure that they carry bratwurst, that they have the real thing.
Oh, okay.
I've considered it.
Okay, all right. Well, maybe you may want to pursue that, and I hope that you find what you're looking for.
Okay, thanks. Me too. I hope I find the right meat. Always looking for the right meat, baby, because that's what life is all about, just getting your hands on the right meat and then making sure it's prepared correctly. 5670560, sinking your teeth into it, and #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Yeah, all you kids out there under the age of 17, you better not be going in and seeing those R-rated movies, because then Bubba's going to get really pissed off, and God only knows where he'll stick that cigar next. Maybe in somebody's
rectum,
if they're not looking out. And by the way, we sure hope that wherever he sticks it, it's one of Nick's great cigars. What a segue, Neil. That's right, because we love Nick's, and Nick's loves this show so much. In fact, that asshole in St. Louis, by the way, why don't you send a letter to Nick's? They've only had 6,000 letters from assholes like you, and Nick still loves us. Oh!
We'll be right back.
teeth, they're pearly white, but their obsession with them's a disgrace. He sings a song, and then it don't take long for their bedroom walls get plastered with his face. He makes them drop, yeah, all them teeny bops, when he's pelvis pumping live there up on stage. Sure, he's a star, but I don't care what he are, and if you think I'm just jealous, that's okay. Don't get me starting on Ricky, Ricky Martin. He might just lose a lot of fans.
Yeah.
Cause if it gets me starting on Ricky, Ricky Martin, I might tell you he really loves a man.
Boy!
You don't get me starting on Ricky, Ricky Martin. I don't care how much that he makes. Cause if you get me starting on Ricky, Ricky Martin, I might just prove the rumor he's a flake.
What is he, a flake? Plane?
That damn faggot. I can't stand him.
1201 and 560 WQM. We got the award-winning Hank Goldberg Show. By the way, Hank was the employee of the month for May, which that memo wasn't released until June 30th, 1999, which was interestingly enough the day I left for vacation. And Hank was named the employee of the month for the month of May, which wasn't released until June 30th by Greg Reed. I wonder what that's all about. Nice going, Air Humper. Wake up. 5670560, pound 560 on the Mobile One line. See, we have a little pool we take every day. I shouldn't probably say this on the air, but we have a little pool we do in here. Like, everybody comes running into this room, and at 2 o'clock when that theme music starts, you know? Yeah, whatever theme it is. We have an office pool to see how many seconds of dead air before the humper will actually find, you know, get started, or they actually open the pot and get him on the air when he's over there at Chula's. There's our good buddy Chuck. Thank you, sir. We're sorry that George was trying to interrupt your big order over there, which we'll never do again since the other people are paying. There's our good buddy Chuck from the sub center on the corner of 441 and 199th, which is Ives Dairy Road. And you don't have to pay any toll to get there, by the way, at least not from here. Not yet. Here's a mobile in Pembroke Pines. Hello.
Hey, how you doing, Neil?
Great.
Hey, good. Just got back. Well, I didn't just get back from Vegas. It was 2 weeks ago I went there. First time. What an awesome place.
Yes, it is.
Awesome, awesome, awesome.
Sure wouldn't want it to be like that here, would we, sir, to have all those great smiling people, young living and breathing people having a great time, spending all their hard-earned money. We sure don't want that here, do we?
The only thing was the heat. The second day we were there was 120 degrees,
yeah.
But no sweat.
Because you're inside all the time.
Well, no, we were outside. Well, I was with the family and everything, and, you know, I don't know how to explain. I mean, I take the garbage out here, and I'm sweating here, and it's 85 degrees. But
yeah,
out
it's
there,
120 out there. It don't feel like more than 115. You're right. Okay, listen, get a new phone, pal. I'm glad you had a great time. Yeah, we don't want anything like that here. See, we're prisoners, okay? We're prisoners. There's nothing we can do about it. We can scream. We can bellyache. Let's just vote
no. On
July 29th. Those of you who live in Dade, I can't vote because I don't live there. But just vote
no. Two
or 300 times, and then after that, we'll figure out what else we do about people like that asshole Bobby Butterworth and Governor Booch and all these other obnoxious, unctuous people. And the people at the Herald who just want to keep saying
no
to casinos and anything related to it because it's so evil. Like, God forbid those cruise ships should be, you know, docking at the ports of South Florida, those gambling cruises. What's Ed Kaplan going to do? I guess he's going to have to swim out to his ships, huh? Here's Fort Myers with a question mark. Hello?
Neil, God.
Yes, sir?
You know, I just have the luxury of having in-laws that live about 10 miles north of Johnsonville, where you get the good brats.
Yeah.
They smuggle them in like cigars when they come down here to visit me every year.
Uh-huh.
And I've been passing brats all week. The other thing is I supplied you
maybe
with...
Maybe that's why George had a question mark on there.
I supplied you with keto sticks about a year or two ago.
Right.
Are you still using those?
No.
No? Don't need it?
I actually never used them.
You never used them?
I mean, don't feel bad. I appreciate it, but I just never... No, I'm not into that thing of going into ketosis.
No. Well, that's good. I'm glad to hear you had a good trip.
I'm more into going into, like, catatonia, which is why I come in here every morning besides looking to get paid.
Okay, getting on the Cuban subject. I used to have a...
The Cuban subject?
Yeah. I used to have an administrator through your mana who was Cuban. What a racist
bastard
he was.
Yeah.
I ended up getting her fired because of racial remarks.
Uh-huh.
I never saw somebody so arrogant in my life.
Really?
Yeah, and if I could just call her a smelly
bitch,
I'd appreciate it.
Okay, maybe she knows Gloria Estefan. Okay,
and,
God bless you.
And
sir.
In closing, Neil?
Passing, yes?
Neil, Scott Plaskin, you're a water-passing douchebag.
Okay. 567-0560, pound 560 on the Mobile One line. We got a couple lines waiting for you. By the way, Joe Costello, good spot there before, but he can't pronounce his name right. No, seriously, you think that because your name is spelled with an A and not an O that it's Costello, but it's not, because you're Italian. A is never pronounced like A. It's always A in Italian. Your name is Costello, and it's spelled correctly. That's right. I'm just giving you a little information. I brought you back my pictures of Milan there in the Duomo, which only cost me about $75 million to go see the goddamn Duomo there in Milan and stay at the Principe di Savoia Hotel in Milano, which is a beautiful hotel, but very, very overpriced. $7 a piece for a small Coke Light. Crazy people. No, thank you. 5670560, I can't afford it. And pound 560 on the Mobile One line. Here's Miami. Hello.
Nick and Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah, by the way, I thought George did a very good job last week.
That's the report. I have no complaints so far. No complaints. He must have done a spectacular job.
Very entertaining. Listen, the reason I'm
and
calling...
And do a job, I'll tell you, filling in doing this show at this time of the year in this town, he must have done a hell of a job.
Well, the reason I'm calling, I was at a dance club down in Kendall a couple weeks ago.
Who is this? This sounds like it sounds like Harvey from Kendall or something.
No. This isn't a prank call.
Okay.
Listen, I was in this dance club and
doesn't this voice sound familiar, George? Sounds like Rich Pachter.
I promise you. Listen, I was at this dance club with some friends, and I walked into the bathroom into one of the stalls, and I locked the door behind me.
Yes.
And I was partaking of a substance that I shouldn't have been using. I was doing something
for the glory hole.
That wasn't cool. But anyway, I was in the stall with the door locked. Next thing I know, there's a security guard on one side of the stall looking down at me, one on the other side, and one from behind. And I immediately dropped what I had, which wasn't much, in the toilet and flushed it.
Rectum.
And they asked me to step out, and I thought I was going to go to jail, but they ended up escorting me out of the club, which was a little embarrassing, obviously, but anyway, what was disconcerting is that I thought in a stall you would have a reasonable expectation of privacy. Obviously,
no.
these people can watch you defecate,
sure,
I guess.
Sure, absolutely, you bet.
I mean,
they're into it.
You're
sitting in there squeezing it, and they're watching squeezing it.
I guess so. Well,
that's
anyone
correct.
Out there that does that, be careful, because obviously these perverts can watch you do whatever you're doing in there. And
hey, I got news for you. The priest, you got those little hidden cameras fixed up on the other side of the confessional booths now. They're having a hell of a time.
I'm sure they are.
Okay, don't do it again.
All right.
Okay, there you go. That was Rich Pachter. He's been doing drugs. What are you laughing about? Didn't that sound like Rich Pachter to you? He had that kind of like, you know, that bad nasal thing to his voice. And speaking of Rich Pachter, you know who we haven't heard from in a long time? Not that I'm complaining. But both your best friend and Rich Pachter's best friend haven't heard from him in a long time. Maybe that carrot juice finally overflowed.
It stinks! In Miami town, at 560 WQAM.
Yes.
Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. I guess you're supposed to know. I'm gonna shag you rotten. Yeah, baby, I'm swinging a lot. You know. Hope you're not a fembot. Yeah, horny. Is that what I make you? Tell me, baby. 'Cause I need to know now. Because Dr. Evil wants to kill me with my little friend, Mini-Me. Yeah, but I still think it's 1969. My chest hair is fine. Yeah, behave. Come on, baby, it's shagging time.
What is that thing that you're eating, by the way? I don't want to catch you with a mouthful of food, but what is that?
It's a chopped steak with onions and cheese and some steak sauce.
Wow. Looks pretty damn good. Not that this isn't good. This is great, but I'm just, you know. Anyway, somebody faxes me about the old Heidelberg in Fort Lauderdale, which I know has been there for about 100 years on State Road 84. It says they got a deli next door with everything you need. And it is. You're right. It is too far out of my way. But nevertheless, this will kill some good time. As Neil continues his search for some of that good meat. 567. We got 600 open lines here. 567-0560. Pound 560 on a Mobile One line. Here's a Mobile in Cutler Ridge. Hello.
Neil, God.
Yes, sir.
I have a question for you.
these people who are putting all these restrictions out for photo ID and, you know, trying to be the Bible thumpers, aren't these the people back in what we called hippies, I guess? I'm a baby boomer, and I know that the people that are trying to impose these things, weren't these the people that were free sex, drugs, and rock and roll? Aren't these the same type of people?
You mean like Bubba? Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, what is it? What's good for the geese isn't good for the gander?
Right.
I raised my kid the
don't
same
do
way.
As I do. It's the old parroting line, you know, don't do as I do as I say.
Well, it's as I did. I mean, I don't know about you, but I was no angel growing up, and I learned from that, and I'm teaching my kid to grow up the proper way. It is, and Bible thumping's not going to do it. I mean, sit down and just talk to your kid. That's all you got to do. And
yeah, the idea that because a kid, 15 or 16 years old, goes to see an R-rated movie, that it's going to change his behavior is so ludicrous and so asinine. It's the same, you know, it's like the people with Prohibition, you know, with booze and with every other goddamn thing.
You're right. And it's like the movie that they just came out with, I forget, Apple Pie or whatever it is, the movie is based towards that group of kids that are going through a hard time that can help these kids come out, you know. With, you
from
know,
from what I understand, a real hard time, yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I hear.
You're right. Have a good one, Neil.
And back to you.
Thank you.
Anybody see that movie, by the way, American Pie?
Not yet. Looks good.
That's what I hear. Sounds like my kind of movie. 5670560, pound 560 on the mobile one line. So let's get a few bratwursts and go see it. Here's Miami Lakes. Hello. Miami Lakes.
Yes, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I wanted to call you and shed a little light on the Cuban thing.
Well, what does that mean? What is the Cuban thing? What does that mean?
The roadblock incidents. And something that everyone is failing to bring up, or at least I haven't heard it addressed.
Back on the roadblock again? I thought that was 2 weeks ago.
Well, I've heard that they're planning other protests and incidents like that. And one thing I haven't heard addressed is the impact that they have when they come here. They act like they just come in, swim up on shore.
Okay, great. Thank you. 5670560, pound 560 on a mobile one line. I am so sick and tired. You know something? I'm going to tell you right now. I don't ever want to hear the word Cuban again as long as I live. When I was in Amsterdam, did I hear the word Cuban?
No.
In Cologne, Germany, Cubans?
No.
How about in Milan, Italy, Cubans?
No.
Did I hear anybody speaking Espanol?
No.
That's it. End of conversation. I don't ever want to hear it again. I sever myself from it. I'm sick of it. I'm saturated with it. I don't want to see any more Cubans swimming around in the ocean when I'm trying to watch Guiding Light on CBS on Channel 4, which I'm forced to watch the local affiliate. I don't want to hear about it. Just kiss the goddamn ground that you're here and you're not down there, and then let's get on with life, okay? Let's move on. 5, 6, 7, you people like this guy and that woman before that's calling the White House looking for somebody to be waving an American flag. Get with it, okay? If you're waiting for that, then you better move to America, which you're not in case somebody didn't tell you already, okay? You're not in America. Now what does that mean on line 3? What does that mean? Korea?
Korea, there was a war there.
Hello?
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir, you're in Korea?
I am in Korea, how about that?
This isn't Paul Korea, is it?
I'm sorry?
I said, how you doing?
I'm doing really good. Well, I was listening to you, and I wish I was back in Miami right now. As bad as it is, I wish I was back over there.
Mm-hmm.
This place is awful.
What are you doing there?
I'm doing my job over here, working for Uncle Sam.
Oh, I see.
I just wanted to call and say hello, see how you guys are doing in Miami, and by the tone of your voice, you're not doing very good.
No, we're doing really bad. No matter how bad it is in Korea, you're way the hell ahead of the game.
Oh, you think so?
It's the end of the world here, sir, believe me.
Well, if you were over here, you'd think different. I mean, this is really awful over here. It's 1 in the morning over here, and I decided to call and say hello to, you know, to my favorite talk show host there. Can I say that?
Sure.
Sure. Anyway, can I call somebody? I really have not been listening to your show because I'm over here. Can I call somebody a douchebag?
Go right ahead, pal. It's America. Last time we checked. Go ahead.
Last time I did. All right, let me call Fernando and Omar a douchebag.
And when are you getting back?
And you take care of yourself.
When you get out of there. Okay, and have a great day. Good luck. Say goodbye. Nothing like talking to somebody on the other side of the world, you know, with that delay, you know, like, huh? 567-0560, #560 on the mobile one line. We got 600 open lines here today. Let's talk about that electric chair, huh? See, even in something as simple as that, they can't do that right in Florida. Even executing somebody. Lethal injection, even a state like Oklahoma, Texas, where they have all those rednecks, all those mugwumps, they've been doing lethal injection for years in those places. Not in Florida. Florida, we have to keep getting these arguments about is old Sparky working right and the nosebleed and was it fire shooting out of his head and all this other crap. Because even something as basic as that, we can't do right. Because this state is run by a bunch of dumb-ass crackers is what it is. That's what this state's all about, a bunch of dumb-ass crackers. Like walking Lawton, who ain't walking too good anymore, the he-coon and the she-coon. And that dead man Buddy McKay that they ran against, the Buchmeister there. Bunch of crackers. Oh, Jesus, I wasn't that serious.
It's just a shame they can't televise these executions.
Yeah.
That'd be a hell of a...
They got a 95 share on that one with the nosebleed. That would have gone over big. Yeah, can you imagine? Well, put it on Fox.
Especially if they had something like a scratch and sniff where you could actually smell it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like for this call.
Hey, anyway, I don't know why you associate me with Rich Pachter. I still can't figure that out.
Because you hate each other like poison.
I haven't seen the guy in over 10 years.
Yeah?
Since you and Stan were doing back-to-back shows.
No, please, don't mention Stan Major, okay? I was in such a good mood up until then. And stop with that heavy breathing, with that phone heavy breathing.
Listen, have you ever heard of a doctor by the name of D'Adamo?
No.
Have you ever heard of the concept of eating for your blood type?
Yeah, that's another one of those old books. That's crap.
That
book.
You got that book?
Yeah, that was out like 5 years ago. I had that sitting around with dust on it somewhere at home.
What blood type are you?
I have no idea. I forget.
Well, you should find out.
Oh, are you what you call with this health kick again? I'm in the middle of a nice lunch here, and you're starting with that crap?
No, I'm not. But you should. There's a section in there where he talks about why Atkins doesn't work for everybody.
Yeah, and what's the reason?
Well, it's just certain blood types, according to him, if you believe the concept, are designed to eat more of a vegetarian diet. Typos, which is the majority of the population, are meant to eat protein, high protein, and for those people it works for.
Mm-hmm.
But for people like me who are type B minus and B negative and...
Your type was Z minus?
B negative.
No, and I don't want to be negative. I want to be positive.
Well, you got to be positive up here. We don't have a Cuban problem up in Boca. We've got a Brazilian problem.
Oh,
yeah, you're at the beach. You see the
But I bet you the dress stores are busy.
That's what I was going to tell you. You see this gorgeous Brazilian girl on the beach. You know, you start getting friendly with her. You're trying to help her on with her bikini, and you find out there's a little extra there. And let me tell you, it happens all the time.
Yeah. I'll bet.
I can't get into it any more than that. I'll have mine chopped off. Well, anyway, just good to be back. I hate to admit it, George did a great job last week.
How do you like that?
He really did. I actually did not tune him out.
are you trying to say the other times he's been on, you've tuned him out?
He gets better every time he comes on. He really does.
Great. Wait till tomorrow. He's going to be sensational. Have a good
day.
Yeah, he's going to be fantastic, because after this, I mean, who the hell needs this? Just keep those checks coming, Greg. 567-0560, #560 on a mobile one line. The famous Paul Harvey Jr., for those who have missed. You know, see, we don't have any people like that anymore. We don't have any of the regulars. We have chronic regulars that we don't want, but we don't have any regulars that we do want anymore. That's all from those days gone by, when it used to be a lot of fun doing this. Here's a mobile in Coral Gables. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, calling about American Pie. hilarious movie.
Yeah.
Basically, anything that could have happened to you when you were a young guy, anything embarrassing, pretty much happens to all of these guys in this movie.
Right.
Getting caught by parents, making it with inanimate objects. I mean, just it's hilarious.
I'm gonna go see it tonight, I think.
Hilarious movie. Guys getting embarrassed, just back and forth. There's a great scene with a internet clip that you'll love. I don't even want to spoil it for you, but a must-see, definitely.
Okay. I'm going to get me some good stiff bratwurst and go and see it.
All righty.
Thanks.
Have a good one.
By the way, did we take our poll yet? Is there anybody in this audience who actually would admit to liking that crap? What is the name of that? I can't even think of the name of his artist again. The Nookie guy?
The one Limp Bizkit.
Yeah, Limp Bizkit. I think the Limp part, he's got that part of it right. Limp as in lame. Would there be, I mean, it's the number one selling album in America. The first week on the chart, replacing the Backstreet Boys, who've been there for like 4 or 5 weeks.
Oh, that's why you're all bitter.
No, I'm not bitter at all. Oh, in other words, that's why I don't like the music? I got news for you.
Oh, no, you wouldn't like that.
Sucks. That's crap. That's the worst swill I've ever heard in my life. I'd rather hear Puff Daddy than hear that, and I'd rather croak than hear Puff Daddy, okay? Man. That is just... But anyway, like I said, you know, there's so many black people who wish they were born white, and here we got all these white guys trying desperately to be black. Just trying desperately, and you know something? It don't work. They can't do it. They cannot. They do not be being black, other than Eminem.
The Beasties.
Which I think the Eminem may have a little black in him. Kind of like Tom Green. You think he's got a little in him? 26 past noon at 560 WQAM. Let's turn on MTV, okay?
Oh.
We're all going to go see American Pie,
oh.
Smoke a little number,
oh.
And get the hell out of here. That's what I say. All you kids out there, don't let your parents or any asshole at Channel 10 tell you kids you can't go see American Pie because it's rated R, okay? As in ridiculous. Just tell them F off and go and see. Just tell them to shag off, okay? Yeah, isn't that, and thanks to Austin Powers, by the way, so much for, because now all of a sudden we can say shag. Isn't that great? We can't say the F word, but we can say shag, which means exactly the same thing, but in British, which is a foreign language, so it's okay. And if you don't believe me, it's a foreign language. On Virgin Atlantic, I can't understand a goddamn thing those people are saying to me. Have you decided... What? What the hell are you speaking, for Christ's sakes? You goddamn crazy Brits. Gives me the...
Yes,
Bush. Wow, honey, this is really good dinner. What is it?
Dog guts.
Dog guts? Is that what I think it is?
I'm not sure.
Run out of ideas for a sit-down meal with the family? Well, head on down to your local dog pound, make that grocery store, and pick up dog guts. They're pre-prepared with just the right amount of tenderizer and are microwave ready. Just scoop, nuke, and boom, dinner for the family.
Daddy, can you pass me some more dog guts, please?
Is it just me, or does anyone else see anything wrong with this?
Dog guts. The more you think about it, the grosser they get. Buy some for your family today.
1231 at 560 WQM. We got 1,600 open lines now, and one call on, we got two calls on the board, one's from Orlando. We just had a call from Korea, so we're doing great everywhere outside of Dayton Broward. But Dayton Broward, not too good. 567-0560, pound 560 on a mobile one line. Mobile in Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
Hey, I wanted to talk to you about the bratwurst. As a soldier in Germany in the 60s, I remember those bratwursts with the round roll.
Yeah.
And the mustard.
Right.
I mean, they were really good, but I've been looking for the meat since 1967. I haven't been able to find it over
32
here.
32 years and this guy still can't find the meat.
I'm sorry, you're not going to find it anywhere.
Yeah, you're right.
As good as it was over there.
I'll have to go back to Cologne, you're right.
Okay,
I'm on my way. I'm leaving right now. Thank you, sir. God bless you. 32 years he's been searching for the meat, okay?
Oh!
Can you relate to it?
Uh-huh.
567-0560, pound 560 on a mobile one line. Here's Orlando. Hello.
Neil, what a breath of fresh air. If those idiots in South Florida only knew what a god you are, they would be calling you in droves. It's just good to hear your voice.
Yes, you're right. They don't know a good thing when they, you know, they just spoil. I spoiled them rotten for over 20 years.
Oh, I believe I moved away about a year and a half ago, and I'm telling you, radio up here is like right-wing rabble. It is so pathetic. So I just want to say I wish that we could broadcast your show here, and maybe I can get a pirate radio station and push it up this far because it blows.
Okay, sir. Have a great life.
Hey, and Neil, can you put me on hold?
For what?
Just so I can hear your voice for another 5 minutes. I mean, I have no way to hear your show up here.
Can't do it, pal.
Oh, thanks a lot, Neil.
See ya. Can't do it. This is a cheap outfit. They're not going to put you on hold for 5 minutes all the way to Orlando. Oh, that's right. It was on his dime. What an idiot I am. No, we can't afford to tie up a line, pal. We got all these calls coming in here, like one and two at a time. 567-0560, pound 560. On the mobile one line. I don't get it. I don't understand it. Other than, of course, the fact that most of the people who live here got nothing to say. You ever start talk to somebody in a supermarket or, like, anywhere? They got nothing to say. go to a ball game. You ever try to talk to somebody like sitting behind you that has no idea of what's going on in the game, whatever the event might be, especially in a hockey game? They're all sitting there going,
yeah,
talking about stuff totally irrelevant. They haven't got the foggiest idea what's going on, but they're having a good time, and they're making damn sure that you're not. Here's a mobile in Davie. Hello.
How's it going, Neil?
Great, sir.
You mind if I call a couple people douchebags?
Yes, I do. 567-0560, #560 on a mobile one line. I mind profusely, okay? I take the gravest exception to your calling somebody a douchebag, okay? You want to call an asshole, that's another story. But don't be calling people DB. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I'm a young voter in Dade County, and I'm just wondering, what do you...
No, think? No.
Just that word keeps coming to mind.
No.
Go ahead.
What do you think is the motive? Why
no.
do you think Pinellas wants this Metro Rail extension? What do you think is his reasoning?
Sir, let me ask you this. What was the reason you think that he did that sudden about-face on that Mickey Arison deal with that arena after he got elected, largely in part of the promise that he wasn't going to do the deal?
Perhaps he knew the people who were building it.
Huh?
Perhaps he was buddies with the people building it.
That's right. Perhaps somebody's getting smeared somewhere along the way, okay? Because anywhere you got a politician that's this anxious to pull off this kind of a scam and to do it as transparently and as brazenly as he is doing, then there must be something more than meets the eye. Why is it that every time Merritt Stierheim comes back to be the manager, the county manager here, we get more Metro Rail, even though the first one was a boondoggle and a waste of $1 billion, every time he comes back here, we get more of the same.
Okay, so thanks. Oh, where are they planning on building this to?
On building what to?
The Metro extension. Like, what place?
Mayor Penis's house and the Herald.
Okay, thanks a lot, Neil.
Just remember.
No.
Okay, you got it? What's that word?
No.
In English?
No.
Spanish?
No.
Italian?
No.
German? Nein. Nein. Just say nein. 567-05, in fact, vote nein times. #560 on the mobile one line. Here's Hialeah. Hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
Penn Dutch Meats, they have the bratwurst.
Do they?
Yes, they do. They do it real fresh. They don't have any of this MSG crap. After a couple of days, if you don't eat it in the fridge, it starts going bad because it's all real fresh.
Got to eat it right away, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And they also have the mustard, Baptamties, something like that. It's a deli-style mustard.
Oh, that Heinrich Himmler mustard, yeah.
Something.
Right from Germany.
Yeah. It's awesome with that. And a little bit of sauerkraut. Nah, you'll be 100% German.
Excellent. God bless you, sir. Thank you.
Hey, wait. One more
thing. Go
ahead.
Take your time.
I'm probably the only caller online, right?
No, you're not.
Oh, okay.
Every line is smoking.
All righty.
Smoking the good stuff.
Great. Alex Penelas, no. Come mierda.
Okay. He said, full of crap is what he said. 567-0560, #560 on a mobile one line. Like I said, we can say shag and mierda, but we can't say and how do you like that? Because that's the American effing way, the American shagging way, baby. Now, how come you got 16 questions on that one that says Overtown? See, those are the ones that get me curious. Here be Overtown. Hello.
Neil.
Yes, sir.
How you doing today?
Okay.
Oh, I was just curious. I don't mean to beat a dead horse, but if you saw the Herald, what happened in St. Louis when they blocked off the road there?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
They arrested a whole bunch of people. Of course, they were dark, you understand.
Well, you know, depends on who's in power.
Right.
Another thing, I just wanted to say, I think it was a great thing that they raised the tolls right before this election, because now the people are nice and pissed off and fired up. Good luck in getting it passed.
No, I think you're wrong. I think that's the reason they did it.
What, to get them to make it pass it?
So they're threatening that there's going to be 11 more toll roads if they don't pass the penny sales tax.
I'm voting no.
Okay, God bless you, sir, and vote early and often.
No,
just
no,
keep saying
no,
that. It keeps going through your mind, okay?
No.
Even him. 567-0560, #560 on the mobile one line. We got the award-winning Henry Goldberg Show at 2 o'clock today. Hank's bringing in some no-dos. Well, it's the middle of the summertime. What do you want? There's nothing going on. All these idiots talking football camp and all that crap. And don't be playing any more of that phony theme, okay? That phony crap you were playing before. Yeah, that one. A little more would be good. And then at 6 o'clock, we got Jim Mad Dog Mandich.
Yes!
Till 7:45. He's going to be the foreplay for the All-Star Game tonight. We got the All-Star Game, 7:45. Am I going to be watching?
No.
No, I'm going to go see American Pie. I'm going to grab me a couple of stiff bratwursts and go see American Pie is what I'm going to do. In fact, I understand in the movie that's generally all that's going on.
That sounds like a good idea.
What?
Going to see that tonight.
Yeah. And I think I got ID. I can probably pass for like 17, at least, maybe 18. 21, that's what I keep telling them. I'm old enough, and they all keep running like a son of a bitch. 21 before 1 at 560, because they keep saying, we're not. Okay. No matter how old they are, we're not. Of course, in Amsterdam, they have a different outlook on life.
QQAM, go fuck yourself.
I got no tan lines, I know that I am hot. I should tell you, got my Backstreet Boys shirt on and my thong underneath. I'm looking so sweet. Yesterday I tried, but Jenny's car broke down and so I lost my ride. But now the sun is shining and we are on our way. Gonna stay all day, gonna oil up with copper tone. On the sand we'll lay at the beach all this summer. School is out, that's a bummer. I'll be stunning, I can't wait. My bikini looks real great. The guys say I'm the bomb. I am tanned and I am blonde. You know I wouldn't have it any other way.
12:45 at 560 WQM. So anyway, this Limp Bizkit thing that you're all into, if he had a brother named Dick, who started a group?
Dick Bizkit?
No, Limp Bizkit. 56705, Limp Dick Bizkit. Yeah, there you go. 567. I tell you one thing, he'd be number one half if he changed his name to that.
Oh!
You know, we go into the commercial break, and we had every line on the board lit up here, and I go in with some false expectorations and come back, and like, bing, bing, you watch him drop off like, you know, like swatting mosquitoes at the goddamn ballpark. I understand that you're very highly motivated and you got no material, but nevertheless, it's getting a little ridiculous. 5670560. By the way, Joe Costello again comes in with another meat report. I guess I finally really found the topic that these people are into, okay? The search for the really good meat. I can relate to that. And one of Joe's friends who happens to be a meat inspector said, definitely do not let Neil go to one of the places that's been mentioned. And I don't want to say it on the air, okay? He said the place was filthy and disgusting, and you don't want to eat the meat from there. But I don't want to mention which place he told me, do I? Do you think? Could I give like a little clue to which place that it was? I better not. Okay, let's go to Miami. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes.
Hey, Neil, what's going on? I want to cover several things.
Go ahead.
George did a great job while you were away. Excellent job, as always.
Everybody's ecstatic about the job he did. So good that he's going to be starting again at 1 o'clock today. So I can go look for some good meat.
And what else? Oh, listen, I had a whole bag of cassette tapes that I, you know, just a big bag of cassette tapes that I've accumulated over the years. And I went on a long trip, so I said, let me grab the bag and listen to see what's on the cassettes to keep the ones I wanted and throw away the ones I didn't. You'll never believe what I found. I have found cassette tapes of you in on Zeta back in 1987. Incredible.
I don't believe it.
You're still as funny now as you were back then.
Yeah.
I still don't know how.
Even without the bird, huh?
The bird, when I listen, you know, I found the bird all right when I was listening to him back then. But when I listen to him now, I'm like, what was he there for?
He was there for free lunch. And about 50 grand a year when 50 grand was pretty good money.
And it was basically you and the bird were pretty funny, but I would listen to the bird. I'm like, you and Captain Dave were good. The bird, I was like, what is he doing here?
Mm-hmm.
And specifically, I remember one day when you called Luke Halpin.
Right.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
Oh, man, we had some great times. And I remember I even had myself taped when I would call you.
Huh.
And you'd be talking to me. I was still going to college.
Yeah, I remember that. We called Luke Halpin, and I think I woke him up, and he hit me like poison after that. Plus, he became a born-again nut.
Great days. Hey, you're even providing fun and entertainment when you don't even know you're doing it.
Exactly.
Hey, for the good old days, could you play Neil Wakes Me Up in the Morning?
Okay.
Thanks a lot, Neil.
Have a great day, bro.
Bye.
Yeah, you can't go back. Let's go back to Zeta. Let's go on FM where the real audience is, okay? This place, they won't promote the hell out of this show.
Neil wakes me up.
Let's go on FM where the audience already is anyhow, huh? I'm over the age of 100.
Drinking my coffee, munching on the donut.
All right.
If you missed the Neil Rogers show yesterday on 610 WIOD, you missed this.
Is this the Bird?
Yeah.
Bird, how you doing?
Okay.
Listen, do me a favor, play anything, because I can't stand listening to you. You sound like a douchebag.
Do what?
Just do me a favor, play anything.
Well, can I ask you a question before you go?
Oh, God, you sound so stupid. I hate to talk to you. Yeah, go ahead.
Well, why did you call me? I didn't call you.
No, just to tell you not to say anything, just play something. Oh, God, can't stand it.
Well, then why are you listening?
Oh, play something already.
Why won't you answer my...
Oh, can't stand him.
You won't... See, he won't talk to me. Oh, we got a car here.
By the way, did we ever find out any more about his condition? We did not. Like I said, the less said, the better. Also, I looked for the obit for Andy, the Andy from the, which I used to, I don't want to say what my nickname was for Andy. That would be bad. Well, he's dead.
Bad Andy?
No, I used to call him the whale. He was a whale of a guy. But anyway, I looked for the obit in the newspapers. I didn't see it. Now, you don't think that we could have been scammed on that, do you, by my close personal friend Adam? That's too serious of a thing. Nobody would do that. And did that woman ever jump off the bridge yet, or we didn't find out?
Apparently it's still going on.
It's still
on.
Going
it's
on.
Unfolding.
On 595 and 441, she's still holding up the traffic and got it all blocked off. Well, what the hell am I going to do about that? How the hell am I going to get home? I got another hour to think about it, I guess, huh?
Might be a good day to go sausage shopping.
Yeah, excellent idea. Go right up university there. Sounds good to me. So thanks profusely to my close friend Jeff Hansen in Hollywood, whoever you are, who was in L.A. and after searching for years for copies of this, finally found two. One of which you bought for me. Thank you, Jeff. Sure is. Jeff, the Thunderclap Newman, Something in the Air. Boy, I've been looking for this for it. Never had it. I had the record. Never had it before on CD. Got it now. Nobody's getting that out of my hands.
Can I borrow it?
No. You can borrow, what's his name, the Limp Dick Biscuit.
I got my own copy, thank you.
You got your own Limp Dick Biscuit? Here's a call from D.C. Hello.
Hey, man.
Yes, sir.
Listening to you on the net.
All right.
I'm originally from Miami, living up here now.
And how do you like it?
It's pretty nice. I'm into technology and stuff. Like, this is like San Jose Junior up here.
Is it?
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty neat.
A lot of Schwarzes up there, though, aren't there?
Oh, not where I am.
Oh, okay. You're
I'm out near Dulles Airport.
Oh, I see.
You know who's on from, they have 11 to 3, something like that, 11 to 4?
Yeah.
Up here, you know who it is?
11 to 4?
Or something like that. You know, the midday show.
Yeah.
After Howard. It's G. Gordon Liddy.
Yeah, isn't that great?
You know, I'd rather listen to him, I swear to God, 10 times over, and I don't like listening to him, but he's
a Nazi, yeah.
I'd rather listen to him than Rush. But you know what? People call him up and just ask him questions. Like they say, hey, I'm getting married in 2 weeks. What should I do?
G. Gordon Liddy?
Yes. It's the weirdest thing to hear people calling him and asking him advice that they would ask Ann Landers.
Uh-huh.
It's amazing.
I just did a B&E and what should I do and how do I get off with it? Yeah.
Yeah. So it's, yeah. God,
I just ate a rat.
The internet.
And,
You even had some net congestion on your... on your download when I listen to you. Sometimes.
I had some net congestion. That's how many people are listening to this show all over the world. You're damn right, man.
Yeah.
That asshole in St. Louis that called me the other day, but he's listening right now. He's got his ear glued to it. He's squeezing it right now. He's so excited.
Yeah. Well, my brother Vic, he's a dish bag.
Okay.
I don't know if he's listening or not, but nice to hear you.
Okay. Thanks for the good news. Have a great life.
Thanks. Bye.
Now, what are you holding? Oh, my good friend Bob Soper is on there. I was just thinking about Bob Soper this morning, probably because I was watching him do the weather on Channel 4. How you doing, Bob?
Hey, good morning, Neil. Welcome back.
And happy birthday again.
Oh, again?
Well, I mean, I wish you a happy birthday the day that it was, but I was going on vacation. I wanted to make sure that it got back to you.
All right, okay. I just want to let you know that that woman, she, apparently her last game was to put both legs over the side and lean forward, and the police sneaked up behind her and grabbed her. And
oh, damn it. I hate when that happens.
Well, some people were saying, push her, push her.
But yeah, that's what I was
those
hoping.
Those were the ones stuck in traffic.
Right.
No, but it's over, so good news for you going home today.
So we got the railway mass murderer. They caught him today, and we got the crazy woman off 595.
Yeah, it's a banner year.
What more could you want?
Oh,
okay,
oh.
Thanks a lot, Bob.
All right, talk to you later.
I'll be seeing you. There's Bob Soper, one of the good guys on Channel 4. Are there any other good guys on there?
No.
Just him. Now, what just happened there? See, I don't understand you people today, man. We get 600 lines all lit up here, and I think we're making a little bit of progress. We're getting calls from D.C. We're getting calls from Korea. We're getting calls from Timu Solani. We're getting calls from all over the world. And then all of a sudden, plink, 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 it's like Plinko on a goddamn Price is Right. And you wonder why I get a little bit paranoid about this whole phone thing we got here? About our friends there at the phone company? You people at the phone company suck! You got it? Oh, by the way.
Hi, this is G. Gordon Liddy, and they don't come any worse than Neil Rogers.
5670560, pound 560 on the Mobile One line. Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I got the info on the bots.
Okay.
Usingers in Milwaukee. It's truly a Schmeck group.
Yeah, but where do you get them here?
Johnson's at Walmart is pretty good. It's not as good, but if you got a few bucks to mail order, they're the real thing.
Okay. Okay, thanks a lot. I think what I'm going to do next time I go to Germany, I'm going to smuggle in $19,000 worth of bratwurst. If it's good enough for the governor's wife, I guess I can do it too, huh? If it's good enough for Columba.
Where are you going to hide it?
Maybe in Columba's
rectum.
Probably wouldn't be the first meat that's been in there. 5670560, pound 560, what?
But that's a sin.
Yeah. Well, maybe she can atone for it at a later date, just like the sin of smuggling and all that crap that she bought from Gay Perry. That was probably a sin, too. Here's a mobile in Hollywood. Hello.
Uncle Neil.
Yes, sir.
I have the answer to your bratwurst problem.
Okay.
Old Heidelberg restaurant on Spirit 84.
Yeah, somebody faxed me that before, but that's a long, long way from me.
They got a butcher shop in there. Their worst are the greatest, man.
Yeah.
Might be worth the ride for
you. Their worst are the best.
Their worst are the best.
Okay, that would be a good advertising campaign, by the way. I'll take only 10%.
All right.
Thanks a lot, pal.
Take it easy.
I'm going to go over there. I think that's a good idea. In fact, I'll just go over there and have dinner one night. And then stop after dinner in the sausage shop and buy a whole bunch of crap and take it home. Sounds real good to me. Thank you, sir. God bless you. That's a good place, by the way. At least it used to be years ago, about 100 years ago when I ate in there last time. The old Heidelberg on State Road 84, which you didn't know or don't know. In fact, it's right on the way to Ruth's Chris. That's a good idea. Next time I get inspired to go over to Ruth's Chris, if that should ever happen again, after the indifferent treatment that I had last time I went. But if I do decide to go again, what I'll do is stop over there at the old Heidelberg in the market. I'll pick up a bunch of bratwurst. I'll walk into Ruth's Chris and say, hey, you want to heat these up for us, please? And we'll just drink some water, okay? Thank you. And we'll take a few of these mints on the way out. They do have good mints. You notice that on the way out? Mmm. Killer.
It's the 1 to 2 hour.
If you had my butt, would you be a great big song? Is it OG? If your butt could compare with my embroidery, would you make money?
Yes.
Your big hat is a portion of fun. Would my career be done? And would this song become number one?
Yes.
Take a look at my rump. Tell me if it burns tonight. Would I be the star of the movie Out of Sight? Then look at me and all they see, my they want to grab it, grab it all day. If you had my bus, would you have a limousine with a big fat seat for your honey? And would you have more cash with a big old shapely ass stuffed into your jeans? I love my big jeans.
Okay, that's our poll question today. Who's got the better ass, Jennifer Lopez, Britney Spears, or Olympic Biscuit is our poll question today. 567-0560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Or to make a long story short, can any of the three of them sing whatsoever?
No.
No. But be that as it may. I'll tell you another group that I would mention this to you before, and you were like non-committal because you don't know who they are. Five, another one of those boy groups, another one of those rip-off groups. Five, and now their new song is like a rap sing, which they can't sing. It doesn't make any difference whether they're rapping it or crapping it because they can't sing worth a crap anyway. Five. As in, on a scale of 500, that's about where their music level is. And all about that whole group, five, I would say, on a scale of 2,000. Just thought I mentioned on TRL, Backstreet Boys, seven nights in a row, back to number one. How come that girl from Gainesville, by the way, that NSYNC bitch, how come that nice young lady never called us back from Florida, from FU? How come she never called us back? She was going back to summer school or something like that and giving me a big song to dance, and I told her that the Backstreet Boys would be number one. This is like ages ago. And sure enough, by the end of that week, there it was, supplanting NSYNC, which sucks. And it's still there, number one again, last night on TRL. Since now that we're all watching the Tom Green Show and watching MTV 24 hours a day and turning off these other goddamn channels, that's what I say. Turn off all the other crap, turn on MTV, and leave it on.
Oh!
Especially Thursday nights at 10:30 and Sunday afternoon at 3 or 4 whenever they decide to put on two Tom Green shows back-to-back. Here's Plantation. Hello. Plantation.
Neil, how you doing?
Pretty good, sir.
All right. Yeah, I had two things I wanted to talk to you about. I heard you mention about the American Pie movie.
Right.
You got to go see this movie. It's the funniest thing in the world. And the great thing about it is that I'm 19. I just graduated from high school last month.
Right.
And doesn't crap around about what's really going on in high school. You know, like sex is so easy to come by.
Right.
It's not, you know. All right, trust me. Unless you're one of these big dumb jocks who can throw a football or put a ball through a hoop, you know, it's not that easy to come by if you're just
right.
A regular old guy. But go see it. It's very fun.
I'm going to go see it tonight.
All right. And the other thing I want to talk to you about was, you know, I've traveled throughout, you know, the United States. I went to Europe last year with my family and everything. And I've never seen any other state or country pander to an ethnic group like the Florida government panders to these Cubans.
That's absolutely correct.
You know, they can just do whatever the hell they want and get away with it. Most people would be in jail if they're blocking traffic, you know, sitting in jail right now.
Like they were in St. Louis over the weekend.
That's right.
They tried pulling that crap there, and a couple hundred of them went to jail.
That's right, being tormented by Bubba in your jail cells, but they're not the Cubans down here.
Yeah.
Not them.
Well, we got a foreign country. You know, Dade County has been taken over, and that's why most of us moved to Broward.
In the United States, these, you know, Hispanics make up, maybe 4% of the voting population, okay? And there was an article in the...
Dade County, they make up probably 94% of the voting population.
Yeah,
they,
that's true.
The old Cubans, they're the only ones that vote in Dade County.
You know, and I don't know what the validity behind this article in the Sun Sentinel was a couple of weeks ago. They said that Al Gore was actually going to ask Mayor Pinga to be his running mate in 2000.
Yeah, they're talking about it. And you know what I say? I say, well, pack him a medianoche. If that's the way we have to get him out of here, I say, let's do it.
And I'm thinking to myself, go right ahead, and I'll go out and I'll vote for George Bush and his ugly puss, too.
Right.
All right.
Okay.
You have a good one, Neil.
See ya.
All right.
Yeah, let's, I say, well, let's just, we'll do write-ins. We'll have Tom Green. This is the choices. Tom Green, Jesse the Body Ventura. That's a good start. No more of these goddamn politicians. They're all the same. They're all a bunch of crooks, baby. It's not just a cliche. They're all a bunch of crooks. They're all on a take. They're a pile of crap. The only guy that isn't a crook is goddamn Ted Kennedy because he's got all the money, and plus he's already killed one woman and done all the crap that he can do, okay? We love old Ted Kennedy. Boy, is he looking old, by the way. Did you see him on there with Bubba this morning? They're doing this health care thing. Wow. That fast living, Teddy, it's going to get to you sooner or later. And he also, what does he weigh, about 240, 280, 100, 340? He looks like Fat Boy on a bad day. So did we ever get any more? See, I'm looking for the obit on my good close friend Andy. I didn't see any obit on that. Maybe that was, I don't know, maybe it was just a hoax. I'm hoping for the best. I'm hoping that I was just, I'd rather that's got a note saying, we just, played a little prank on you, and Andy's doing fine.
Somebody would have called to say it was a hoax by now.
He's not alive? He's not coming back? He won't be at that first hockey game this fall? Come on.
No.
Please tell me he'll be there.
He died.
Just say he'll be there.
He won't be there.
Here's Deerfield. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yes, sir.
A couple things I haven't talked to you. Welcome back, number one.
Thank you so much. It's so great to be back.
Yeah, I can imagine.
I'm doing okay.
Hey, you got me, Jones, and I was over in Cologne, Germany a couple years back. And, oh, God, those sausages, you're right.
You know where they have the best bratwurst in the city, at least the ones that I had?
Mm.
Right at the train station.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, God.
In the train station, they got a whole bunch of little shops there, little food shops and so on. And there was, I tried a couple different places, and there was one that was just sensational. Some of them are a little bit too greasy,
Right.
Oh, this one was just fantastic.
But it was truly amazing. You'd walk along these little shops and and they'd have a little grill outside, like a hibachi.
Right.
And then you would just smell that, and you'd go in there for a snack and
beer. When were you there?
This was a few years ago, and I was in the summertime.
I've never been in a city in my life where there were more beautiful people than the people in Cologne, Germany. You could just sit. They have that one big shopping mall street. It's called Hohe, H-O-H-E.
Okay.
And it's like a closed shopping mall, and there are very ritzy, expensive shops in there of all kinds. And you just could sit there and people watch all day, and just with your tongue down to your toenails, it's unbelievable. Seriously.
You fit in like a glove over there, I bet.
Yes.
Okay, that's one thing I was going to talk to you about. Another thing was that I'm disgusted with all the way they're allowing the Cubans to block the streets, and I've just never seen, they could have a protest if they want, but blocking the lives of people and endangering
people. Well,
that's
what I said. If you want to have a protest at the appropriate place in front of a building somewhere, but not to go out there and mess up people's lives and screw up the whole roadways, for Christ's sakes.
Absolutely unacceptable, and they should be ashamed because we rolled out the red carpet to help them, and now look what they're doing to us.
Exactly, spitting in our puss.
That's right, and in closing...
And doing it out loud, too.
In closing, for my friend Jermaine that's healing up in Boca, shameless request, nobody rips you back.
Okay.
Thanks, buddy.
And have a great day. Okay, it's 9 minutes after 1 at 560 WQM. We're solving all the problems of the world here today.
Oh!
By 2 o'clock. Then we're going to go out and get some real good bratwurst, smoke a little weed, and then go see American Pie tonight.
Oh!
Sounds good to me. Now, that 19-year-old young man that called a couple of calls ago that said it's not all that easy to get laid in high school, how do you like that? See, there was that big article they had the other, it was yesterday in the paper, about the Broward kids and about there's not as much sex, they're not as many sexually active. That's not by choice. It's just they can't get as much as they used to. Not by choice, okay, because believe me, trust me when I tell you, okay, the one thing that they would tell you.
I wanted it.
You bet. They would tell you that. That doesn't necessarily mean you're going to get it.
I wanted it.
Yeah, I kept hearing that. By the way, are we ever going to see him again or not, huh? I guess we won't see him no more.
JC?
No, not him. Well, you had the first initial right.
Oh, the other one.
The other one.
The other CT.
Yeah.
No, I don't know.
Probably not.
I've seen him around.
You've seen him around where?
Around here, like in the afternoon. Long after you've gone home.
Oh, he's playing hard to get?
He didn't make it worth his while, I guess.
Well, guess what? I did a lot better over there. Didn't cost me a dime, just like always. A lot better. I mean, no problem. No conversation, no big song and a dance, no games, no tease, no,
No hairy chest?
No, oh. No muskrat chest. That was only on a plane. That was only Austin Powers on the Virgin Atlantic plane.
Neil God.
By the time I get through the next couple of minutes, she is going to have to pick every scab off that putrid, pus-filled body of hers, all right?
Nobody rips you better.
So I'm going crazy on this, yes, because this has got to stop. You make me sick, Pat, you bitch! God! How is it possible to be so stupid, Pat?
Nobody rips you, and I'm so good at you.
You idiot, you asshole, you.
Baby, he's the best.
Well, sing this, you fat slob. I'm going to take this cord, and I'm going to shove it right up his ass, okay? And I'm going to shove this thing so far up his butt that he's going to be singing a different tune when I get through with him. Don't we have a longer cord than this piece of crap? Look at this. Look how short this damn thing is. We've got 100 assholes running around this building. They can find another one besides him, although maybe not that big. No, get it out of there. Go pull a cord somewhere. Go do something. Pull what? In your case, a good question, okay? God.
Nobody rips you better.
don't start looking, once again, as always, to blame fat old Neil for whatever you're upset about. You disgusting, nauseating old slobs.
Nobody rips you and acts
good at me. Old, crabby old bitches.
Neil, if you don't repent, you're going to split hell wide open.
Yeah, I'm going to split it wide open. You know, I'm going to split wide open your skull with a mallet, devil. You stupid old bitch.
Ah!
There we go. Now we're cooking. What did I just get through talking about? It was old bags. We don't want you, lady, okay? Go get some knitting out. Go find some crossword puzzles to do. Go get,
okay, Resendez Ramirez, the railway killer, the mass murderer, the serial killer has been captured. In case you missed it,
oh!
And the Bob Sober reports that they got that lady off the 595 overpass there by 441.
Oh!
What else? What more could you want? Here's a, boy, you ought to read this. I don't have time to read it on the air. This poor bastard was coming back on Continental from Vegas through Houston. And what he went through, I mean, I couldn't, oh, geez, I'm ready to blow my brains out, and it wasn't even my trip. Sorry about that, Ed, one of our listeners out there who made the bad, bad mistake of flying Continental Airlines. Bad move, man. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, my good friend who comes to the hockey games all the time, the airline pilot, that bop, 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 bop. Yeah, he's a good guy, but he talks a lot. Bop, bop, bop. He works for Continental, so I shouldn't have said that, but... 5670560. Hey, listen, I tell it the way it is, okay? I'm not going to lie for anybody unless I get a lot of money for it, which I don't. Five, and even for these people here, am I, they paying me enough to lie for this joint?
No.
No way. Boy, do they suck. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. Yeah, I'm debating, you know, on the way home whether I should stop for bratwurst or maybe like, I don't know, banana split at Baskin Robbins sounds good. You know, the Baskin Robbins, the drive-thru one on 163rd in North Dade there? What?
Don't do it.
No, I don't mean a banana split. I'm just talking about like a hot fudge sundae with nuts, whipped cream, and cherries. On
they taste the same as they always have.
You're
not missing a thing.
You mean like the one I had about 3 weeks ago?
It'll be no better than that one.
Oh, then it ought to be great. That's a good place. Baskin Robbins drive-thru. It's like heaven. And the best part of it is it's only like a few blocks off the interchange there. At 163rd, so you can drive from there like 30 seconds right on the turnpike, and you hold the sundae like in one hand while you're paying the toll. How do you like that? All you assholes, you incompetents that can't pay your 50-cent toll in Dade County? I can drive through the turnpike toll thing there at the Golden Glades, eating a hot fudge sundae from Baskin Robbins, pay my 75 cents, no problem at all, and zip right up the old Hershey Highway back into Broward. No problem at all. An old fart like me, an old fuddy-duddy fag like me, I can do that. And you people out there are sitting around fumbling for it, and a goddamn change, too. Shame on you. I think there are a bunch of actors out there. I think that's why he brought ringers in here. You know, most of the people are out of town right now. It's the middle of July. I think the mayor imported a bunch of ringers here. In fact, maybe all those illegal alien Cubans, they put them all in the car, and they're the ones that are playing all this baby crap by the toll booths, pretending the traffic's all backed up. We're on to you, Mayor. Mayor Pinga, you're not fooling anybody, you piece of turd. Straight to jail. Here's Fort Lauderdale. Hello? Fort Lauderdale.
Yeah, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Do me a favor. Do not go to Penn Dutch.
Yeah.
There's a place in Lauderdale. It's just north of Commercial on Federal Highway. It's called Emily's.
Yeah.
It's the world's best. All they do is make homemade sausage.
Really?
Yep. You walk in, it's a mom-and-pop operation.
Emily knows her meat, huh?
Oh, it's just ungodly. It's the best. Without a doubt, do not go to Penn Dutch. I'm serious. Once you go there, you'll freak out.
Okay.
All right?
I'll go see Emily.
Right.
Thanks. Yeah, in fact, that's the second person today that said do not go to someplace. 5670560, pound 560 on the AT&T wireless line. That's where it's at, baby. Hank Goldberg's coming up at 2 o'clock today to cover all the heavy-duty sports news. Then about 2:15, he'll get into some really good stuff. Well, there's nothing going on in sports, okay? What can I tell you? It's just a really dead time. The All-Star game tonight. Does anybody care about that?
No.
We got 655 teams. You do realize, by the way, that teams like the Marlins that have been out of the race for, like, what, for about 2.5 months now, that they still got 70-some-odd, almost 80 games to go? You do realize that, don't you?
Uh-huh.
And like John Henry says, we stink. We don't expect anybody to show up. The team for at least a couple of years is going to be really grotesque. We're going to lose our ass. So why would you want to go? Why would any person in its right mind go when they tell you ahead of time? Like I said at the beginning of the show today, it's like somebody standing out in front of his restaurant saying, the meat all spoiled, okay? Our freezer unit went out during the night. All of our meat is rotten. You're going to get some horrendous disease, and everything we got in there is spoiled. It's going to taste like crap. We can't afford to lower the prices, so we're going to gouge you like crazy. But if you want to come in, and people are coming in, that's what it would be like. I don't understand these people. Talk about lifeless and clueless. Oh, yeah, but we got to take our kids to a ball game. Take them out to see American Pie tonight instead, okay? Take your 5 and 10 and 12-year-old kids to go see a really funny movie. Take them to go see Austin Powers. Take them to go see South Park. Here's a mobile in Cooper City. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
Yes, sir.
I just saw Mayor Pinga handing out pesos down in Miami. Those pesos won't fit in those machines.
They'll fit in his
rectum.
Tell you that.
And as far as Penn Dutch, you can put me down as the third guy to say forget it. But,
yeah.
There is a place called International Homemade Sausage in Pembroke Pines.
Yeah, I had about 18 calls on that.
Well, that's the place to go. All these people are giving you places east. That's out in your neck of the woods.
That's the one on University.
It's on University, just north of Johnson Street on the west side. It's
right.
A hole in the wall place. A Polish guy's been there. He's been making them for years.
Hmm.
Did you hear the interview this morning with Jimmy Johnson on the worst team?
No.
He was you know, there was a lot of suction going on.
I had a lot of CDs playing in my player in the car.
Well, I wish I had a few more, but he was the Tony Martin issue came up and you know how he would be a great player if he stays out of jail, and Jimmy said, "Well, Tony didn't have anything to do with the drug dealing end of it, so he's okay. So I guess you can be a money launderer and play
right.
with the Dolphins. You just can't deal drugs."
Yeah, he was just being a Chinaman. You know, he was just doing a little laundry number.
Right, that's right. And Neil, in closing, Pool Todd, don't give me any more work. I'm schvitzing out here.
Okay.
Thank you.
He's schvitzing over there. Yeah, Tony Martin, he don't look Chinese, but nevertheless, maybe he's turning Japanese. 5670560, #560 on the AT. We haven't had one call today about Olympic, what's his name? What is his name?
Biscuit.
Oh, Biscuit. A Tasket of Tisket. Kill that Biscuit. Oh, man. That is so lame. All I can say about that song is...
Pick it up your ass.
Yeah. See, and that's the only reason that song is popular, because they just keep saying, stick it up your ass over and over again, you know? And there's certain songs like that.
Well, they say Nookie a lot.
And there's one song, which some rapper, which is very big in Europe, which is just making it, they were talking about having it on MTV, and I have no idea how they're going to bleep it out, because he keeps saying F, and it sounds like he's saying F-I-U, which it's got nothing to do with here, but he's saying F-F-I-U over and over again. What is that? Is he
F the world, maybe?
No. F-I-U, he's saying. Maybe he's from UM.
Uh-huh.
That might be it. FFIU. Probably sour about some damn volleyball game. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
How you doing?
Great.
I just called in when you played the bit about Jennifer Lopez.
Yes, sir.
I just want to say that ever since she became more appealing to both white and black audiences, it looks like she's losing weight, man. In the beginning, she was thicker, man. Her butt was big, but now...
She's got a scrawny butt.
She's got to get skinny so she can cross over to both. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So,
but she'll wind up losing that Puerto Rican constituency. They like the big butt.
Well, see, I like, she's going to lose me because I'm black. So
she's going to lose all the Latins. The Latin guys, they got to have a big butt.
I got to have it. I'm black. I got to have it.
Right.
So she's out of the picture now, man.
Yeah. Now, what about Britney Spears?
Nah, that's not me either.
Black guys aren't into Britney?
We're not into Britney, man.
Yeah.
We're not into Britney. But I mean, you can keep playing a bit, but it's she's lost it.
She's history. She's dead meat.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, man.
Thanks for the good news.
Okay.
There's a bulletin from the bro, okay? He say she's dead. She be dead.
I don't know. I've seen her butt lately. It's plenty ample.
No, you haven't seen her butt. You keep seeing the same video over and over.
No, not the video. She was doing some thing on the beach. She was wearing a bikini.
I'm going to say to you the same thing I said yesterday. And again, I have magnificent taste. And that is that from the neck up, she needs serious help. She ain't nothing.
Oh, I agree.
From the
I thought we were talking about her butt.
Well, you're talking about her butt. I'm not into butt, okay? I don't care about her butt, your butt, anybody's butt. I'm not into butt. That's a Cuban thing and a Schwarzer thing, like this, you know, bro that was just on air 2 seconds ago. Maybe that was the Olympic Biscuit doing a voice. Well, you know, he's trying to be black. He's trying real hard, and he still sucks, Limp Biscuit. Yeah, that's what I say, but that horrible, awful, oh, man. And it's embarrassing. Jesus Christ.
I think it's a them.
What?
Not a him.
No, I understand that. But if it's a them, you can't say if he had a brother named Dick. You say if they had a brother named Dick.
Maybe they're all brothers.
Maybe they're all brothers, huh? That could be it. Well, in any case.
Pick it up your ass.
Suck it in and hold it. The king of pop is
by the borders on sanity. And if you think we accept, that's a great big lie. Now and then I see my kid's face. I'd like to see him, but I don't have a case. If I try too hard, my money will go bye-bye. I'll never see that child in my eyes. Oh, I never see the child in my eyes.
131 at 560. WPM got some very bad news, by the way. Bad news. You know those hockey games this fall and next winter? Andy will not be at the hockey games. You were right. You were saying he's not going to be there. You were right. Got confirmation. Somebody faxed me the obituary, Andy Kroll, Peter Andy Kroll, 36, originally from Pennsylvania. Died suddenly Friday, July 9th. Andy was an Eagle Scout, a graduate of the University of Miami, a proud member of Pi Kappa Alpha, known and respected in the automobile business for 15 years, a strong supporter of local collegiate and professional sports, a great Panthers fan.
Oh!
His exuberant personality and quick wit will be sadly missed. Et cetera and so on. I already got it, Adam. Thank you. So I already got two copies of it. A third one will put me over the edge. Don't do it. So it wasn't just a hoax, even though I know that Adam, being a good guy, not the Adam, our salesperson, but Adam from the hockey games who faxed me the thing yesterday, he wouldn't do something as tasteless and crass as that. But nevertheless, you're always hoping maybe it was just a prank. Maybe it was just an April Fool's Day on the 12th of July. Was it an April Fool's prank?
No.
No. Andy's dead, and Andy was 36 years old, and Andy was fat. Maybe I better skip that Baskin-Robbins, you know? What?
Please.
Well, I wasn't seriously going to go to Baskin-Robbins. It's out of the way, isn't it?
Yeah, way out of the way.
No, it's not. It's right on the way.
Wait for something new and exciting to come out in the world of ice cream, or like another fish food or something like that.
And when's that going to be?
Oh, just hold your breath.
Yeah, I'm holding it.
You know you'll regret it if you have.
Oh, by the way, we didn't get one call on. Okay, now, of course, these people have no idea. That's Toy Box, which is another group from Finland, I think. Finland or Sweden? I think Finland. Where was Aqua from?
Sweden.
Sweden? Like I said, they're from Sweden. And they're like identical. They even look like them, and their music sounds the same, and they're huge all over Europe. And Toy Box. But anyway, you already heard that, and of course they hated it like poison. I was thinking there's also another huge record which will make it big here. Guaranteed, whether you agree or not. She's from Finland, by the way. Her name is Lene Marlin, as in, oh, the Marlins. Anyway, it goes on. It's 4 minutes long. You don't want to hear the whole thing, but never, it's going to be big. Trust me when I tell you. You heard it first here. Lene Marlin, unforgivable sinner. And the video, well, anyway. Here's a lady at Mobile in Tamarack. Hello.
Hi, Neil. How you doing?
Great.
That's good. Welcome back.
Thank you so much.
All these idiots telling you Emily's and all this, that's Amel's, and it's in Pompano on Federal Highway.
Yeah. Well, Emily, Amel, it's got some of the same letters, as in nitrate.
But I thought of something while you were away. There was a picture on the front page of the Sun Sentinel the day after the botched execution.
Yeah.
A mother...
That was just very nosebleed, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, who cares?
Yeah.
I don't care if they bleed at every hole. But some mother and her two young children, 6 and 7 or something, were outside the execution holding signs up, why do we kill people who kill? And here this mother drags her children out at God only knows what time in the morning to pray for the poor soul who's being executed.
Really?
I thought, you know, that's a great mother there taking her kids out in the middle of the night. But, oh, well, I don't know.
Maybe we ought to start praying for the kids.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Maybe they should stop having babies or...
Oh, God!
Yeah, forced sterilization sounds good to me.
Well, definitely, but I have...
Take the kids out of the trailer at that time of night?
Oh, I know. You know, we're from Winter Haven, so I don't know how long
it's going to
get there. But right
that
on the front page
all.
Of the paper, you know, these kids are going to be, like, really messed up when
Lakeland,
they get older.
Winter Haven, Lake City, yeah.
Hollywood.
So is everything you need to know.
But also, I had a flower delivery to Little Miss Britney Spears, and I thought of you when she was at the Pompano Beach Amphitheater, I had a nice flower arrangement that went to her, congratulating her on her first night of her first tour, and thinking of her OAs, love, Jay. So that made me think of you also.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, she's a little, I don't know. No comment.
She's a little what? She's a little bit country and a little bit rock and roll?
Well, they, you know, they're like, well, these flowers are for a very special person. I'm like, well, you know, everybody's special, you know. She's nothing special. She's a 17-year-old dancer, you know.
With big boobs, yeah.
Yeah, well, she doesn't look as good
in
person.
A cute face.
Put it that way.
She wasn't that good in person? She was disappointing?
You know, before the makeup and everything, you know, she just looked like any other 17-year-old.
It's amazing what they can do with makeup. It's just astonishing.
Makeup and boobs, really, you know.
Yeah, it worked for Nick Carter, too. The makeup wasn't bad in those that boob job. It did it for Nick. Okay, listen, have a great day, sweetheart.
Thanks, Tom. Can I make a request?
Yes, you can.
I'd like to smoke two joints.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
And how about the bit? We'll play that, too. She wants to smoke two joints, one in each corner of the mouth.
She hoover out the moon, man. Here's the guy, he sucks, okay?
Okay. Roy!
I smoke two joints in the morning. I smoke two joints at night. I smoke two joints in the afternoon. It makes me feel alright.
Alright!
I smoke two joints in time of peace and two in time of war. I smoke two joints before I smoke two joints. And then I smoke two more. Oh, my daddy, he once told me, son, you be hardworking man. My mama, she once told me, son, you do the best you can. But then one day, another day, man, came to me and said,
what?
Hard work good and hard work fine. First take care of it, so now I smoke two joints when I get up. In the car I smoke two joints. I smoke two joints when I play video games. And at every 10,000 points, I smoke two joints.
Unbelievable.
I smoke two joints in time of peace and two in time of war.
Yeah.
I smoke two joints before I smoke two joints. And then I smoke two more.
I want to give you a kiss. Okay.
That's all with you, Lucky.
Unbelievable.
Oh, my daddy, he once told me, son, you be hardworking man. My mama, she once told me, son, you be best you can. But then one day I met them man, came to me a day.
You turd.
Hard work good and hard work fine. First take care of it. That's why I smoke two joints in the morning.
Oh!
I smoke two joints at night. I smoke two joints in the afternoon.
Yeah.
It makes me feel alright. I smoke two joints.
Are you?
Okay, 13 till 2 at 560 WQM. In a couple of minutes, we're going to be previewing the new single by Limp Wrist Biscuit. Isn't that its name? Limp Dick Wrist. Here's, what is it, St. Johnsbury, Vermont?
Hey, Neil.
Yes, sir.
Just wanted to let you know we've got some listeners in the real world.
Oh, my God. We had a call today from Korea. We had a call from, where? A few places.
Holy smoke. You guys live on a different planet.
Yes, we do.
It's unbelievable.
We live on Uranus.
Just interesting to note, though, that the more the wheels come off of your government, the more entertaining it is for us.
Exactly.
Keep up the good work.
God bless you, sir.
Thanks.
And say hi to Ben and Jerry.
You bet.
Okay. Well, I'm telling you one thing, that lunch is starting to work. Like the Four Seasons says, working my way back through you. Remember that song?
Uh-huh.
That's what it's doing right now. Thank you so much, by the way, Chuck, for interrupting a very busy day. He's a hell of a guy. Chuck over at the Sub Center. He's been real good to us, I'll tell you that. Here's a mobile in West Palm Beach. Hello. Mobile in West Palm. 26 minutes and 29 seconds, and they're gone. And we were paying for it. That's the bitch of the whole deal there. 5670560, #560 on the AT&T wireless line. Here's Miami. Hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Okay, sir.
I just want to let you know there's some of us out here pissed off and fired up about this sales tax.
Oh, you're the one, huh?
Yeah, I'm the one. You know something? Every time you open the paper, if there is no more corruption in Dade County or City of Miami and they still need extra money,
mm-hmm.
I don't have a problem with that. But when a guy's filling up his boat and his car to go fishing and putting it on a city gas card, or you look at the port scandals, I mean, they advertise under 836 about how the airport is the third busiest in the world. In the port of Miami is one of the busiest ports in the world,
mm-hmm.
and they can't make any money, and there's not a problem.
Yeah.
You know, something I honestly think.
And the best part of the whole deal is that, the county and city governments are in bed, as is the Herald with Mickey Arison, and most of the money that he makes, not a penny of it goes to the county or
right.
the U.S. government or anybody else, because it's all registered to other countries, all his ships.
Yeah, but you know something? I think it's as simplistic as saying if we had a real newspaper who did some investigating and stopped all the crap.
But we never will. We'll never have it.
I think it really starts there.
Yeah.
I mean, nobody's looking out for it. Mm-hmm. You get more information out of the New Times reading an article about corruption in Dade County than you will in the Herald.
Right.
You know, it's just tired. I did move to Broward, but, you know, I do work in Dade, and I run a business here, but I just, it's sad. I grew up here all my life, and I'm only 33 years old, and I hate to sound like an old man, but
yeah.
I tell you what, this town used to be great. I used to live in Westchester, moved out to Kendall.
Right.
It was a great town.
You're right.
It's sad. Go down, drive. You haven't driven down A Street in a while. Oh, my God. It's over. It's, you know, people, it's really bad, and it's just, it's not getting any better, and people... How much can people spend? When's enough enough?
Yeah.
You know, it's as simple. When is enough enough?
I'll see you on County Line Road.
See ya.
10 till 2 at 560 WQM. 567, we got one guy there that's pissed off.
Oh!
Fired up, thank God for that. Don't forget, just say,
no.
Tell all your friends.
No.
Vote early and often.
No.
Pingo, okay? Just tell them to do.
Oh, my God.
Get up your ass.
Something like that. Just like Limp Dick Biscuit would say. Even the name of the group, you know, Limp Bizkit. I mean, what does that tell you? How bad, how really and truly bad. And George likes that. Doesn't that tell you everything you didn't know about his music, about your taste? Awful.
Yeah, but you like that toy box.
Yeah. Well, you know something? If you saw the video, it's a novelty record, okay? They've even done a remake of The Witch Doctor. Not Toy Box, it's some other group
Ooh,
that sounds like. Yeah, exactly, yeah. Yeah. In fact, I'm going to bring that in tomorrow. If we don't get a lot of calls tomorrow, I'm playing the goddamn witch doctor. Ooh-ee-ooh-ah. Yeah, David Seville turning over in his grave. I like that toy box. I hate to break the news to you, but Europe is so far ahead of us, not just in music, but, of course, in everything. But musically, I mean, they're like light years ahead. Like Aqua. Aqua was big here, which that was also, I'm not saying that was a good record, Barbie doll, but it was cute. It was a novelty record, and the video was good. It was well done. Well, this is similar, almost exactly the same, but better. And Lenae Marlin, you're telling me you didn't like, you loved Lenae Marlin. Even his eyeballs were rolling, but he didn't want to admit it because I'm the one that brought it in, and he'd be admitting that maybe my taste wasn't as bad as he usually claims that it is. Plus, the Backstreet Boys are just tearing him up all over the goddamn world. I mean, just